God, I'm Kevin Kelly, along with Bruce Pritchard. A big hour in store.
Introducing first, representing Kayentai and accompanied by Yamaguchi-san, weighing 187 pounds, Taka Michinoku.
And Kevin, this past week at the WWF, it has been full of controversy for sure. Taka Michinoku in the ring. Welcome once again to Shotgun, everybody. We're getting set to see X-Pac take on Taka. But certainly, a lot of the focus centers around the Survivor Series deadly game. A week away, Bruce, we're going to crown a new WWF champion.
Exactly, Kevin. We're only a week away from Mr. McMahon's guarantee of a brand new World Wrestling Federation champion. And Stone Cold Steve Austin is in the tournament.
X-Pac, you think you can tell us what to do?
His opponent, representing D-Generation X, from Minneapolis, Minnesota, weighing 202 pounds, the World Wrestling Federation, European Champion, Evita!
While Stone Cold is in the tournament, The Rock is out, all because of Mr. McMahon. We'll show you the boss's rampage later on in the hour. And everybody who thought that Mr. McMahon was dead and buried, I think, may have pronounced it that way a little too soon.
Well, I believe I said it last week, but I said that the day Mr. McMahon retires is the day Mr. McMahon dies.
Mr. McMahon is guaranteed a new WWF champion at the Survivor Series, a deadly game. And X-Pac is in the tournament. As you see down on the bottom of the bracketing, he'll take on a real man's man, Steven Regal, in the first round. But of course, star-studded field and all, Stone Cold is in, but he's going to have to take on the Boss Man.
Stone Cold not only has to take on the Boss Man, but to become WWF champion again, Stone Cold must defeat four top WWF superstars in one night.
Nice leapfrog by Taka. This match is going to be going about 78 RPMs, folks. Taka, of course, in this non-title match, has a title opportunity of his own coming this Sunday on Sunday Night Heat. A chance for revenge against Christian. An opportunity regained.
Take a look at this, Kevin.
Title.
Watch Taka go up.
Watch out! Unsullied Moonsault takes the European champion down.
Tremendous action. And interesting first round matchup.
Oh, wait a minute. Watch out. Yamaguchi saw with that flag.
Oh, across the back. An interesting first round matchup. X-Pac against a real man's man, Steven Regal, who believes that Steven Regal, he believes he should be the European champion.
Well, certainly Steven Regal not making friends and influencing people here in the World Wrestling Federation. X-Pac on the receiving end of some early punishment. You gotta wonder, is X-Pac looking past Taka, thinking about deadly game? Live on pay-per-view next Sunday.
I think every World Wrestling Federation superstar involved in deadly game is thinking about that night in St. Louis at the Survivor Series.
Taka now sending X-Pac across. Misses with the clothesline. Waist lock. Tries for the belly to back break counter by Taka. On his feet first. Hurricane Rana another. What a counter. Powerbomb and X-Pac now back on his feet. So resilient is X-Pac. Steven Regal's going to have to be on his game. Oh, face first.
Tremendous impact. And we could very well be looking at the next WWF champion in X-Pac.
Oh, look at the crowd on their feet. Bronco Buster time. Say hello to X-Pac. Yamaguchi-san gets a little receipt from before. Taka up on his feet, showing his resiliency.
Up to the top rope, beautiful drop kick.
And now Taka Michinoku signaling for the Michinoku driver. This would be a huge upset. Here he goes. No, sir. X-Pac counter. X-Factor. That'll do it. Lateral press two and three.
And Yamaguchi-san was a little too late.
Oh, wait a minute. Kayentai. Kayentai coming in. Teo takes one.
There's Funaki in now. He's gets a spin kick togo from behind.
Wait a minute now. Come on. Kayentai doing a number four on one. Oh, wait a minute.
Here they come. The Outlaws to the rescue.
Road Dog, Billy Gunn, Lindenhouse.
They got issues of their own.
Oh, no. Wait a minute, Bruce.
Whoa, Billy Gunn's got towel up. Where's he going to put him?
Anywhere he wants. Look out. Oh. Survivor Series could be huge for DX. The New Age Outlaws will defend their titles against the yet-to-be named opponent. And X-Pac with an awesome opportunity to become WWF champion. For more on Deadly Game, though, let's take a trip to Slam Jam.
Yes, guys, X-Pac is in the Survivor Series Deadly Game Tournament, and I'll tell you what, he's got the endurance to win it. It's possible. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Slam Jam. Can you believe we're 1 week away from Survivor Series Deadly Game? Next Sunday, November 15th, from the sold-out Kiel Center in St. Louis, Missouri. 8 o'clock Eastern, 5 o'clock Pacific, live exclusively on pay-per-view. You know, Survivor Series is always great and controversial, and we are guaranteed to crown a new WWF champion in a one-night tournament. The names in the tournament, I mean, The Undertaker, Kane, Triple H, the leader of DX. Now, you know, The Rock was in the tournament, but because he did not defeat Ken Shamrock for the Intercontinental title, Mr. McMahon has said he is not in the tournament now. But I heard The Rock is going to find Mr. McMahon on Sunday Night Heat. We also found out Stone Cold will be in the tournament, but that's not all you'll see. You'll see the WWF Women's Championship on the line, Jacqueline defending against Sable. Let's take a look at their rivalry and then hear from the women's champion.
Jackie, first you took my belt, and then you took my hair.
Sable thought she got a butt kick. Well, wait till she get in the ring against me now.
That belt belongs to me, and I'm coming to get it.
I'm gonna beat her like she stole something. That's a promise.
So be prepared for the fight of your life.
See, this what makes me mad. I'm the centerfold, and Sable is on the cover. Sable, you always think you better than me. I took your man, I took the hair, and baby, I took the title. And Survivor Series, you ain't getting neither one of those back.
What a matchup it's going to be. Both of these ladies have been training very, very hard, and you know they'll tear into each other. You've got to wonder what they might tear off of each other. Don't miss it. It's next Sunday. Survivor Series Deadly Game, 8 o'clock Eastern, 5 o'clock Pacific, live exclusively on pay-per-view.
Mr. McMahon was back with a vengeance Monday night, and no one escaped his wrath. The highlights still to come.
Plus, the people's champ, The Rock, will face off against the marvelous one, Mark Barrow.
Oh, but up next, the bizarre one, Goldust, takes center stage. Shotgun continues.
They're big, bad, and bone-crunching. They're WWF bone-crunching buddies. Listen to all the bone-crunching attitude that is Stone Cold Steve Austin. Do love Shawn Michaels and The Undertaker. WWF bone-crunching buddies. They're bad to the bone.
Bless me, Father. I killed a man.
Since last summer, Julie James has lived in terror.
I have these horrible dreams.
No one believes her stories.
He was in there.
And where is he now, Julie?
No one understands her fear.
Ben Willis is dead. They never found the body.
But her secret is about to haunt them all.
We're all gonna die! Good cops, one by one!
I still know what you did last summer. Rated R. Opens everywhere November 13th.
You didn't dial 1010321?
I admit it, Oscar. Sometimes I forget.
I told you, dial 1010321 to save money. 50% when you talk over 20 minutes.
I know, I saw my phone bill, and those 1010321 calls were much cheaper.
And it's so easy.
I know.
So from now on, you'll always dial 1010321 first, right?
Oh, yeah. I learned my lesson.
Pretty good advice, huh? Maybe I should be the trainer. Who doesn't want to save 50%?
I don't feel safe when I'm home alone.
When your safety is on the line, will you know how to react?
Don't take chances with your safety. I'm Terry Barr. Watch Fox 11 News for safety solutions. Tuesday at 6, we'll give you a situation and test you on a solution. Call Fox 11 News with your answer, and at 9, we'll find out if your answer is a safe one. Plus, an expert will show you why the solution is correct.
Watch Safety Solutions, Tuesday at 6 and 9.
Ready to party tonight? Hot and wild bands want to rock with you. Call 1-800-450-WILD. Call now and get a free hot sample. That's 1-800-450-WILD. ready to take a walk on the wild side. Come on. Let's party. Call now.
Welcome back to Shotgun, everyone.
The contest is scheduled for one call with a 20-minute time limit. Introducing first, accompanied by Babu, weighing 275 pounds, Tiger Ali Singh.
This week, Shotgun is brought to you by JVC Kaboom Box, a portable music system with dual subwoofers and 52 watts of ring-shaking power. JVC Kaboom Box, strap it on.
And by the motor oil that provides maximum protection, Castrol GTX, drive hard.
And by Starburst Fruit Chews. Need a boost? Give it some juice.
His opponent, from Hollywood, California, weighing 260 pounds, Goldust!
Will it be a Shattered Dreams production for Tiger Ali Singh in this contest? But what about Terry Runnels or Bruce? Maybe we should say Marlena. Certainly a rough bout, the only incident of the night. Kane went on a rampage. We'll show you that later on.
You know, Mr. McMahon also on a rampage all Monday night. No one was safe.
I'm thankful I stayed clear. Broadcast colleagues, WWF superstars, how about Shaquille O'Neal? He even got lambasted by the boss.
How about Shane McMahon?
That's true.
Vince's very own son was not safe. He was, well, Mr. McMahon made him a referee. Mr. McMahon made him what Mr. McMahon called a lowly referee.
He stripped him of all of his power in the company, busted him down to the rank of referee.
You know, let's hear what Tiger has to say here.
I cannot believe that the WWF expects someone of my royal stature to fight someone like you.
A little high and mighty, you think, eh, Tiger?
Wait a minute. There is no way, and I repeat, no way that I will allow this deviant peasant to come in contact with my royal skin.
I guess he's gonna forfeit.
Therefore, and I repeat, therefore, Babu, I order you to fight tonight. You heard me.
Well, this is hardly... I mean, come on.
Babu's not a wrestler.
Look at him.
He's a servant.
I mean, I can understand spreading rose petals, preparing meals, washing clothes, doing all of the things that Babu does.
I mean, look at that look on Babu's face. He's scared to death. Goldust doesn't look too concerned.
Oh! Whoa!
Goldust just clotheslined Babu right out of his shoes.
Yeah, those little pointy shoes went flying all over the ring. And now, Goldust, with Babu up on his shoulder, Babu is about half the size of Goldust. I'd hardly say this is fair for Tiger to send his servant in to face a man who could be WWF champion at Survivor Series.
Well, Goldust will be facing Ken Shamrock, the Intercontinental Champion, in the first round of the Deadly Game Tournament. It'll be much more competition than he's facing right now in Babu.
Wait a minute, Babu with a bit of a shortcut there. I don't think Babu knows what to do with this offensive advantage. Fires across it.
That didn't work.
Tries a clothesline. Trying it again, barefooted and all.
One more!
I don't think one more is going to get the job done either. That time, Goldust boot right in the midsection.
And Babu caught in a bad part of town. Look out below. Powerbomb! First time I've ever seen anyone powerbombed in rose petals. I'll tell you what, Goldust is looking great. And I wonder what is going through his mind now that apparently Marlena, Terry Runnels, what's the difference? It appears that she wants to try to reconcile.
Well, we saw both. We saw Terry Runnels, who came out with Val Venus and told Val Venus that she was pregnant. And then it was Val's child. And then just this past Monday, we saw the reemergence of Marlena, Goldust director.
Yeah, but whether she's Terry or she's Marlena, according to her, she's pregnant. Val denying it, folks. Val denying that he has anything to do with Terry Runnels being pregnant.
Hey!
And Babu once again on the receiving end of a rather rude treatment by the bizarre one.
And, you know, we haven't yet heard Goldust's opinion on this whole situation.
Goldust now takes Babu down with a clothesline. First lateral press attempt, no sir. Not even going to bother at this point. Goldust to take on Ken Shamrock. Jeff Jarrett to take on Al Snow. X-Pac, Steven Regal, Stone Cold, and the Big Boss Man. Just some of the first round matches in Survivor Series Deadly Game. 1 week away on pay-per-view. Three count is told. I guess that's the move that Goldust now wishes to be called the Oscar.
Well, the Oscar was very successful for Goldust this week here on Shotgun. Defeating Babu, but it wasn't a Tiger Ali thing.
Will he be the king of the world at the Deadly Game? We'll find out. Still to come on Shotgun, nobody was safe from Mr. McMahon's wrath Monday night, not even his associates.
And up next, we'll hear from the Tag Team Champions of the World!
There's this thing going around called sniffing. You think you're getting high, but the dizzy, fuzzy feeling is just what happens when your brain doesn't get oxygen. The chemicals get in the way. So it's like you're not breathing. That's how sniffing causes brain damage. Death. So when you think you're sniffing, your brain thinks you're drowning. And your brain is pretty much right.
I cannot wait to stomp out for my new moves.
I'm gonna do a board slide into a 720 stale fish. You're gonna bust a rodeo flip off that kicker, man.
I'm gonna huck myself off that kicker into a 1260 Indie grab.
Yeah?
Yeah!
Let's do it!
34 courses, 35 maneuvers, and thousands of combinations. Cool Borders 3 will put you right on the mountain. The rest is up to you.
Oh, that was sick! Did you see that? That was sick air, bro!
989 Studios.
No little cinnamon gum freshens breath longer than Big Red.
Get close a little longer, kiss a little longer, hold tight a little longer, longer with Big Red. That Big Red freshness, that's right through it. Your fresh breath goes on and on while you chew it. So hold on a little longer, make it last a little longer, keep your breath longer.
Why does this always happen to me? It's my turn to cook. It's getting late. I know the kids are hungry. We can't do another night of freezer food. I just don't have time to cook.
Help! I have a dinner emergency!
Does this scene look familiar? Don't let this tasteless tragedy take place in your home. Learn how to create a quick, well-balanced meal. Watch Dinner Emergency all week on Fox 11 News at 5. Each night we'll bring you an easy, time-saving dinner tip. Looks like I got here just in time.
Live your fantasy tonight. Talk live one-on-one with exciting women. We'll talk about whatever you want. Private live action. Get your free hot sample. Call toll-free 1-800-7000-HOT. That's 1-800-7000-HOT. For your free hot sample, call toll-free now.
Oh, you didn't know? Your ass better call somebody!
New Age Outlaws back for a second time here in the hour. We understand the tag team champs got something on their mind. A lot of teams gunning for him, Bruce.
The Headbangers, as well as D'Lo Brown and Mark Henry, both would like a shot at the tag team.
I want to give a shout out to somebody at home, Triple Johnson, Beast, New.
I don't know all of Road Dogg's friends.
Oh, that was a piece out for Triple Johnson there.
Everyone is on their feet. They are warming up their voices. I think they're all going to join Road Dogg in their well-known slogan.
Cut the music.
Feel free to do it at home, too.
Kevin, sit down.
Ladies
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, children of all ages, D-Generation X proudly brings to you its WWF Tag Team Champions of the World, the Road Dog Jesse James, the Badass Billy Gunn, the New Age Outlaws. You damn right. Now then, let us touch on, for just a minute, the butt bangers.
Wow.
Not literally. You see, I like to touch on things that wear skirts, don't you? But they're usually named Tracy and Tina. You see, that's how it goes. We like women butt bangers.
I believe they're referring to the
we head bangers. Also like our World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Championship titles. So you can keep yours that you got out of the order form catalog from the World Wrestling Federation. You ain't coming near this gold.
I think you can get those belts at ShopZone. WWF.com.
I've seen that.
Look, he's going to let me talk.
That's a first.
This could be scary.
Now that I have the mic, I guess let's talk a little bit about my...
Oh, no!
Oh, no.
Please, let's not talk about that, Mr. Rob. Well,
I'm going to get to that. All right.
We could be here okay. All weekend.
Let's talk about the two guys that couldn't make it as singles, so now all of a sudden, they think they become a tag, and that is Mark Henry and D'Lo Brown.
So far, that tag team's been very successful.
D'Lo Brown, the self-proclaimed European champion, which I know good and well you're from New Jersey, and Mark Henry, who thinks he's the strongest man in the world, and I guess he went to the Olympics, right? Well, Mark Henry, let me assure you, you didn't win gold there, and you will not win gold anywhere with us either. Now,
yeah, but they're going to have to defend those titles.
Now the chance you've all been waiting for.
If you're not down with that, we got two words for you. Hell.
And I wonder if that announcement is made anytime soon, if the Outlaws will be still showing that same kind of bravado.
Well, we're going to find out very shortly, but I'm sure Mr. McMahon will have an announcement this Sunday night.
Still to come on Shotgun. Marvelous Mark Merrill steps into the ring against the number one contender, The Rock.
And up next, the headbangers meet two butts in tag team action.
Are you ready?
Welcome back, everybody, to the Totally Twister Game Center, along with Grandmaster Robbie.
Excellent.
I'm Michael Cole, and today on Game Center, we're going to play Mega Twist, which happens to be Grandmaster Robbie's favorite game, so I'm going to let him describe it for you.
It's excellent. Excellent.
George and Adam are standing by right now with more insight.
The object of Mega Twist is for each player to hold down a different button with a different body part until each button is pressed.
Whoa, and you're at three skill levels, Tame, Tough, and Twisted!
Speaking of Twisted, let's go to our game room where the human oddities are playing Totally Twister. Well, looks like they're having a blast, and so can you with Totally Twister. What do you think, Grandmaster Robbie?
Two words. Excellent. Excellent.
Next week, Kai and Ty joins us to play Totally Twister.
Wanna play again?
To win.
And poodle-loving lady attacks punk rockhead with her flying attack poodles!
I play to steal my opponent's heads.
He fires back with atomic up! She's taking his head! She took his head!
I play because I look good as a baby ninja.
Enter the twisted world of the Heads Arena! Battle to collect 225 heads, each with its own weird, wild, and whacked-out weapons and powers! And the head-hunting game on CD-ROM, you sure are losing.
May I help you?
If I wanted a whopper, no pickles, that wouldn't be a problem. But would we get to hear you sing?
No, sir. You get to hear us sing.
Hold a pickle, hold a lettuce, special order donuts.
May I help you?
If I want my value meal with rings
instead of fries,
is that a problem?
Value meal with rings or fries, it still costs a great price. You don't have to ask us twice to have it your way.
When you have it your way, it just tastes better.
Motivate Sir Anthony Hopkins?
Lunch. Here's my lunch.
And country music star Travis Tritt. Next, Rosie.
Weekdays at 4 on Fox 11.
Fox 11 knows when severe weather will threaten your neighborhood, and we can tell you when and where it will hit with pinpoint accuracy. If you live near Highway 151 in Valdres, Fox 11 can warn you 5 minutes sooner than any other Green Bay station.
First Track Live Doppler Radar. Every other television radar is last.
Ready to party tonight? Hot and wild babes want to rock with you. Call 1-800-5000-HOT. That's 1-800-5000-HOT. Take a walk on the wild side. Call now and get a free hot sample. Hot and wild babes want to party with you. Come on, get wild. Let's party. Call now.
The bottom line for StoneCold.com is it's a record setter already. The launch last Tuesday, folks, drew more people than any other televised internet event. Stone Cold and I got together. We had a great time. The first of many interviews, I understand, on StoneCold.com. Log on now. Oh, here we go.
Fat, stupid, ignorant, illiterate slobs of all ages, the family of freaks and heavy metal music proudly brings to you its real WWF Tag Team Champions of the... You bunch of morons, we are the Tag Team Champions of the Universe! Mosh and Thrasher, the Headbangers! And if you're not dealt with the fact that the universe is much, much bigger than the word, then we got two words for you. You suck!
Two words, Bruce. Inferiority complex.
Well, very nicely put, Kevin. And speaking of complexes, how about while we were in the break and Too Much got in the ring and Brian Christopher took the microphone?
Yeah, I love you, man. Hey, come on. All the gestures and all the... It makes a lot of people uncomfortable, I'll tell you that. Big shoulder block by Mosh now. Starting off on Too Sexy Brian Christopher. Big drop kick from Brian.
Like a, you know, he sounds like a hyena when he laughs like that.
And I'll tell you, his number one fan, other than himself, of course, is Scott Taylor. He thinks that Brian Christopher is the greatest thing ever. It's amazing.
You're just too much.
Making a wish on Mosh. And certainly, the Headbangers, I know, had their ears pressed to the door when the New Age Outlaws were in the ring. And I gotta wonder if the Outlaws are bothered by the Headbangers. They were mocked pretty well by the Headbangers, a real page out of the Outlaws playbook last Monday on Raw.
Well, it was very obvious that the Outlaws were bothered by the Headbangers. Otherwise, I don't think that the Outlaws would have brought up the Headbangers, or as they call them, the Butt Bangers.
And of course, D'Lo Brown and Mark Henry, after the breakup of the Nation, you said it, Bruce, they've done very well for themselves, and they've put themselves in a great position, I think.
Just this past Monday on Raw, the Headbangers faced D'Lo and Mark Henry. There was no winner, so we still don't know which team, the Headbangers or D'Lo Mark Henry, will get a tag title shot at Survivor Series Deadly Game.
Well, you got a couple of dancing fools.
Oh!
Not exactly the way they should have been doing that. Little team celebration gone awry.
Well, you had it right when you said they were fools.
Tag now, Maine. We'll see if the Headbangers are able to take advantage of the missteps of Scott Bryan. Launched across, clothesline off the second rope.
Tremendous teamwork by the Headbangers. They know where each other is at all times and work very well as a team.
The Headbangers D'Lo Mark Henry match, of course, was put into ruin by Kane. The presence of Kane. You can just feel this man just running amok. And does he have any morals at all? I mean, what is Kane's problem?
I believe that Kane is a very confused young man this time.
Help, Jimmy! Boom!
Well, certainly, with Paul Bearer as his only moral compass for some 20 years of his life, I mean, really, what type of individual can he be? Take a look now. Great action by the Headbangers.
And here you see Mosh coming up, leapfrog, and nails Christopher.
Not too many other tag teams have the teamwork down that the Headbangers have. Brian Christopher and Scott Taylor, both members of Too Much, finding that out. Shoots the half, float over, count of two. That was close.
How about that when Kane did hit the ring? Did you see the height that Kane got when he chokeslammed both Mosh of the Headbangers and D'Lo Brown?
Incredible. And of course, folks, we'll show you in a little while Mr. McMahon with that steel cage hanging above the ring. Promised someone was going to do hard time.
Someone did hard time, all right.
Yeah, three people indeed. Clothesline now. Great move by Too Sexy. Couldn't get the cover, though. I'm a little surprised. Sacrificed the cover for the opportunity to make a tag.
Well, you talk about three people doing hard time. It was more than the Stooges that did hard time last Monday. Mr. McMahon took out his frustrations on everyone that he bumped into last Monday night.
And Too Hot Scott Taylor taking some frustrations out now on the members of the Headbangers. Whether it was announcers, whether it was WWF superstars.
How about WWF fans?
Yeah, celebrity guests and even The Rock. You'll see that. Uh-oh, Christopher coming right at us. We'll show you Mr. McMahon back in the saddle again and what that meant for everyone this past Monday in just a few moments. But bad things are coming for Too Hot Scott Taylor.
Oh!
I mean bad things. Double flapjack, and this one is over.
Well, the tag team champions of the universe, the self-proclaimed tag team champions, are victorious.
Was that a title match? I guess we'll never know. Headbangers are victorious.
All right, everybody, welcome back to WWF Slam Jam, and we are just 1 week away from the always great, always controversial WWF Survivor Series Deadly Game next Sunday, November 15th, from the sold-out Kiel Center in St. Louis, Missouri, 8 o'clock Eastern, 5 o'clock Pacific, live exclusively on pay-per-view. We are guaranteed to crown a brand-new World Wrestling Federation champion. We are going to have a one-night tournament, and the names in this tournament read like a who's who's list in the World Wrestling Federation. The Undertaker, Kane, Triple H from DX. Also, we found out that Stone Cold Steve Austin is now in the Survivor Series Deadly Game Tournament. But WWF owner Mr. McMahon said in the first round, Stone Cold will meet the Boss Man. So we tried to go to Mr. McMahon and find out what the Boss Man's motivation would be in this tournament. But instead, we ran into his head of security.
I've done told you guys one time before, nobody's allowed to speak to Mr. McMahon. All this is handled through me. But while you're here, I got a few things to say. Steve Austin, you're walking around acting like you don't care about nothing or nobody. But I know for sure that you do. Everybody does. Well, at Survivor Series, you're going to be facing me. You're going to have to step in the ring with a man Mr. McMahon is trusted to make sure law, order, and justice is served. Little side note, I'm kicking your ass. Now get out of here.
Now, you see what I mean? I think the Boss Man's motivation is not to win the WWF Championship at Survivor Series Deadly Game. It is to prevent Stone Cold Steve Austin from regaining the World Wrestling Federation Championship. And what about The Rock, the People's Champ? He is out of the tournament, but I heard on Sunday Night Heat he's going to find Mr. McMahon. Don't forget Sable against Jacqueline for the WWF Women's title. It all happens next Sunday, Survivor Series Deadly Game, live exclusively on pay-per-view.
Still to come on Shotgun, the People's Eyebrow will be fixed squarely on Marvelous Bark.
And up next, Kane goes on a rampage. All the highlights from Raw.
Do you smell what The Rock is cooking?
He's the people's champion. And when he raises the people's eyebrow, he's about to lay the smack down and catch you with the people's elbow. Now it's your turn to lay the smack down with the people's t-shirt. The Rock's Laying the Smack Down t-shirt. To own yours, call 815-734-1161. Visit the WWF Shop Zone website or send $25 plus shipping and handling to the address on your screen. Know your role. Order now.
Eyebrow Pick!
Let's rock. Want some?
Here at VMI, we were asked to try the new Norelco Advantage for 21 days. That was quiet dissension.
I'm not giving out my blade.
And anxious inquiry.
What the heck is this? Goo?
But then we started to realize the lotion actually gave us a closer, smoother shave than we expected. Without the nicks and cuts like blades, our fear diminished. Our hopes arose, and life got a little less hairy.
Come on, baby face, move it!
The new Norelco Advantage. Put it to the test. If you don't like it, they'll give you your money back, guaranteed.
In Risk, the world is your battlefield. You are the general, strategically leading armies across borders, attacking, defending, counter-striking, conquering everything in your path. To take over not just a country, but the entire world. Risk, the game of global domination.
He's cheating behind my back.
With her not being in the house for months at a time, I went out and strayed.
She says they were legally separated. She says she was just away at school.
With my husband, I don't know anything about he cheating me.
She takes and takes and takes and runs me into the ground.
Oh, sounds like a sordid mess to me.
Yes, ma'am, it sure is.
Justice with an attitude. Judge Judy.
Weekdays at 5:30 on Fox 11.
Hello, I'm Mike Flanagan of the Green Bay Packers.
And I'm Terry Barr of Fox 11 with a very important message for women in Wisconsin.
According to the American Cancer Society, 3,600 women in our state will be diagnosed with breast cancer this year, and nearly 900 will die from it.
Early detection is your best protection.
And guys, whether it's your mother or your wife, encourage her to have regular mammograms. Believe me, it could be the most important thing you ever do for her.
From your home team, WLUK, Fox 11.
Live your fantasy tonight. Talk live one-on-one with exciting women. We'll talk about whatever you want. Private live action. Get your free hot sample. Call toll-free 1-800-7000-HOT. That's 1-800-7000-HOT. For your free hot sample, call toll-free now.
T98 Survivor Series, Deadly Game, from the sold-out Kiel Center in St. Louis. Next Sunday at 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific on pay-per-view, is proudly presented by Nestle Crunch. It's just more fun to munch. And one man who is on the outside now looking in the Survivor Series will be Marvelous Mark's opponent.
For the 20-minute time limit, introducing first to be accompanied by the World Wrestling Federation Women's Champion, Nick Roman. From Buffalo, New York, weighing 235 pounds, Marvelous Mark Sparrow.
And that, of course, is The Rock, basically because of Mr. McMahon. A lack of love for the people, and you can say the people's champ.
And the people's champ having to feel the wrath, Mr. McMahon. Just this past Monday, having to face Ken Shamrock. The condition? If The Rock didn't defeat Shamrock and become the Intercontinental Champion, The Rock was out of the Deadly Game.
And that meant he had to win by pinfall or submission. He did win the match by disqualification. And what about that little clandestine meeting our cameras caught? Shamrock and Mr. McMahon having a word before the match?
Well, we'll never know. Mr. McMahon claims that he was merely wishing Shamrock luck.
Huh. On a night where Mr. McMahon lambasted everybody, he gives Shamrock words of encouragement.
Do you smell what The Rock is cooking?
It could happen.
Well, it could. I'm wondering what The Rock's state of mind is.
Well, The Rock says that he's going to be in Sunday Night Heat. This Sunday night, he, being The Rock, is going to confront Mr. McMahon.
Mr. McMahon's going to have some splaining to do, I think. He had The Rock arrested for a number of charges, Bruce. Seemingly, I
think The Rock is just reacting to the emotion of the situation.
I believe Mr. McMahon charged The Rock or claimed that The Rock destroyed property.
Well, he didn't
threaten Mr. McMahon. I believe there was even something in there when The Rock slammed the horn and it was too loud.
Oh, well, that's going a little close. But certainly The Rock saw his opportunity to compete in Survivor Series, the Deadly Gate Tournament, to become WWF champion. Apparently go by the board this past Monday. And I think that's a shame. So The Rock will lock up down with Marvelous Mark Merrill, who is going to have a tiger by the tail here, I have a feeling, in this matchup.
Well, The Rock, just this past Monday, he looked great in his match against Ken Shamrock. The Rock looked as if he was on his way to once again becoming Intercontinental Champion. And a blatant disqualification by Ken Shamrock. Could that have been at the direction of Mr. McMahon?
Could very well have been. Merrill walked into a right hand. And The Rock now back in Merrill into the corner. Cross to the other side. Of course, outside the ring is Jacqueline. Jacqueline with her own Survivor Series champion. Oh, wait a minute. Merrill catches The Rock coming in. Jacqueline's going to defend the WWF Women's Championship against Sable, who I understand is in some very heat preparation.
I understand that this Sunday night on Heat, we're going to get an opportunity to take a look at Sable's training technique.
Training garage be able to overcome the experience and to get WWF Women's Champ.
And look at The Rock. The Rock giving Merrill some of those people's fists to the side of the head.
And now Jacqueline trying to distract The Rock, and I think did more harm than good. Not exactly the same boxing skills, but a good use of the hard right hand.
No doubt about it. And The Rock taking his frustrations out right now on one Marvelous Mark Merrill.
Of course, not only on Heat will we hear a response from The Rock to Mr. McMahon's actions of last Monday, but Mr. McMahon will be there, as will we understand Mr. McMahon's associates, or do we call them former associates?
I don't know. I call them stooges.
Well, are they former stooges?
Only time will tell.
Is it once a stooge, always a stooge?
In my book, it's once a stooge, always a stooge. And again, this Sunday night, we'll see if Patterson, Briscoe, and Commissioner Slaughter show up at McMahon's side.
Slingshot over the top. First lateral press of the match, too. The Rock able to get out. Was it just tough love that Mr. McMahon showed the stooges? Was it a payback for what he felt was ill treatment in his hour of need?
Well, I think it was just the fact that they were really late to the back of the cup.
Merrill boots in the midsection. High knee lift. And Marvelous Mark is carrying the battle to the People's Champ. Could this be an upset? Shotgun continues.
Get ready to rock the house. Godzilla is alive, now on video. Rock your house with Godzilla, now on video cassette and DVD.
The national radon test is about to begin. Radon enters your home from underground. A Harvard University report ranked radon number one in a list of home hazards. Computers give off radon. Windy days can increase radon levels in your home. Office of the Surgeon General strongly advises all homes be tested for radon. Rainstorms can produce higher levels of radon in your home. Radon is the second leading cause of lung cancer. You can call 1-800-SOS-RADON to find out how to get your family's home tested and made safer.
Tuesday, Peggy enters a beauty pageant.
Do you think I can win?
No matter how I answer, there's a bullet in every chamber designed to blow my brains out.
But beating Kathy Ireland and Carol Alt will take an amazing makeover.
My butt looks like it's dragging on the floor. Will you fix it?
We need duct tape.
An all-new King of the Hill. Then, the human skeleton. The world's tiniest baby. And, you think your job stinks, meet the professional foot sniffer. An all-new Guinness. It all starts Tuesday at 8, 7 Central on Fox.
Ready to party tonight? Hot and wild babes want to rock with you. Call 1-800-5000-HOT. That's 1-800-5000-HOT. Take a walk on the wild side. Call now and get a free hot sample. Hot and wild babes want to party with you. Come on, get wild. Let's party. Call now.
We're back on Shotgun, and Marvelous Marcus continue to carry the battle to The Rock. You gotta wonder, is The Rock's mind in this following the disappointment of this past Monday?
I think that The Rock is focused on one thing, and that is confronting Mr. McMahon this Sunday night.
What disappointment for The Rock. A lot of people said the People's Champ was the favorite in the tournament. Mero hoisting the trunks, so he's very confident.
Well, I think The Rock feels that in a lot of ways that The Rock got screwed because The Rock was the number one contender for the WWF Championship.
Well, thanks to Shane McMahon, Stone Cold is back in the tournament. But The Rock not so fortunate. Rock back on his feet, firing back on Merrill. Merrill staggers out of the corner. Oh! DDT clinched him, center of the ring, hooks the leg. This should do it. Two and... No, sir, Merrill's still too strong.
Well, Stone Cold Steve Austin may be back in the tournament, but my God, how about that first round matchup against the Big Boss Man?
The Big Boss Man waylaid not only Mr. McMahon's associates, but also Stone Cold with that nightstick.
And how about when the Stooges were paying hard time and Stone Cold Steve Austin entered the fray? It was Pat Patterson who took the nightstick and nailed Stone Cold Steve Austin. Rock bottom!
The rock bottom delivered.
I think I know what's next.
To say that it is a phenomenon would be an understatement.
There is no one sitting down. This entire capacity crowd on their feet.
Unexplainable to some, the people's elbow to the wrist. Loud breath, this one is over.
The Rock said, it is all over.
I wonder what The Rock is going to say to Mr. McMahon. A public confrontation to the WWF owner. How far will The Rock push the owner following his elimination from the Survivor Series Deadly Game Tournament, which is 1 week away on pay-per-view. Sunday Night Heat, 7, 6 Central on USA. For Bruce, I'm Kevin. We'll see you then. Begin hours from now. Welcome everyone to Shotgun. Along with Bruce Pritchard, I'm Kevin Kelly.
The following contest is scheduled for one ball with a 20-minute time limit. Introducing first to be accompanied by Babu, weighing 275 pounds.
Kevin, we are only hours away from Mr. McMahon's guarantee. We will crown a new WWF champion this Sunday night on pay-per-view.
We'll talk all about who's in the tournament, what Mr. McMahon's thoughts are, and what indeed will happen on Sunday Night Heat preceding Survivor Series Deadly Game. Certainly could be very interesting, very electric when we're live.
Yes, it could. And speaking of guarantees, another thing that we guarantee is that you're going to get all 3 hours and you will see a new WWF champion crown on a WWF pay-per-view. That's guaranteed.
Tiger Ali Singh will take on Val Venus on Heat live at 7, 6 Central right before Survivor Series. But he's got a tough test right now.
Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, weighing 243 pounds.
And with Scorpio, you gotta wonder where some of his friends are, Bruce.
Well, Scorpio's got a lot of friends, and I think you're referring to Bob Holly and, of course, Al Snow and Head. And wherever a member of the J.O.B. squad is, there's always more lurking.
Certainly, Scorpio, Bob Holly, last week made quite a debut as a tag team on Heat. But Scorpio set for singles action here on Shotgun on a Survivor Series weekend. What an event it is going to be, folks, this Sunday night, live on pay-per-view at 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific.
And how about it, Kevin? The Rock is back in the deadly game this Sunday night.
Oh, we're going to show you what happened this past Monday on Raw. And Mr. McMahon, not happy about what went down at all. Just off the lockup, Bruce, Babu having to towel Tiger off.
I wonder if that's because Babu bumped into Tiger earlier on or because of Scorpio.
He is an oily sort of lad, isn't he? Wait a minute now. The chase is on. Tiger coming back through the ropes. He's not going to win a foot race with Scorpio, that's for sure. Duck under. Great drop kick. Tiger Ali Singh on the receiving end so far.
Oh, nice maneuver.
He found confidence in Scorpio. Head of steam.
Look at that.
Well, that was smart, Tiger, but you look up in the ring, and Scorpio is ready for you to get back in.
I don't think Tiger's going to be a member of Mensa anytime soon.
Well, he is Asian royalty, of course.
That's true. Well, Tiger now getting back into the ring, and folks, we know that Sunday Night Heat precedes Survivor Series Deadly Game, and Bruce, every WWF superstar on the card is going to be in the house.
Well, we do know that, Kevin, but what we don't know is who is going to be the opponent for Mankind in the first round of the Deadly Game tournament.
Those question marks on the bracket certainly leaving a lot of questions in everyone's mind. And Tiger burying a knee in the midsection certainly seems as if Mankind has formed a very strong familial-type relationship with Mr. McMahon.
Familiar? He's one of the family.
That's right, familial.
I mean?
Like a son.
Yes, Mankind refers to Mr. McMahon as Dad.
Oh,
maybe well, Mankind should change his name to McMahon-kind.
Very interesting proposition. And, of course, remember, folks, Mr. McMahon set these brackets up. This is his creation. Wait a minute, lateral press, first one of the cup, first one of the match, gets to the two count. I mean, notwithstanding the fact that the big boss man is taking on Stone Cold Steve Austin. Talk about hand-picked placement.
Indeed, but you look at also the Undertaker and Kane. They both threw a bye. They will face each other in the first quarterfinal matchup.
You gotta wonder, does Mr. McMahon hope that these two destroy each other, leaving nothing in their wake? Certainly, their previous battles could lend itself to that.
Of course, and you have to wonder about the condition of Triple H. Triple H and The Rock scheduled now to square off in the first round as well.
Of course, The Rock is back in, folks, and we'll show you all that went down this past week on Raw a little later on in the hour. Scorpio now eludes the grasp of Babu and knocks down Tiger once again. Scorpio has maintained the advantage over the bigger Tiger Ali Singh, now going to the top. Uh-oh, first mistake of the match.
Nobody home. I wonder if Mr. McMahon is going to reveal to everyone, including Mankind, who Mankind's opponent is going to be this Sunday night live on Heat before the pay-per-view.
We do know that Mr. McMahon will be on hand. Will he say something to The Rock? We understand he plans on making a statement to the People's Champ. Got to know if that's concerning Survivor Series. And folks, Heat is live this Sunday. We'll be there at the Kiel Center. All the action live at 7, 6 Central on the USA Network. That, of course, takes you right to 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific, Survivor Series Deadly Game on pay-per-view.
Of course, last Monday night on Raw, Mr. McMahon felt the people's elbow, courtesy of the people's champ, The Rock.
Had to have been humiliating for the WWF owner. Scorpio showing some signs of life.
No! No!
Tiger Ali Singh will do battle with Val Venus this Sunday live on Heat. Plus, all the competitors at Survivor Series Deadly Game will be in the house. Scorpio back on his feet now, trying to free himself. Rat-a-tat-tat to the midsection. Misses with the clothesline, does Tiger. Same for the elbow. Oh, what a move. Tremendous spin kick. Lateral press doesn't hook the leg. Two. Oh, that was close.
That was close. You're talking about all the WWF superstars being in the house at Heat. You have to wonder, will Kane be in the house? The last we saw Kane, he was on his way out of the arena, choke slamming a fan, almost choke slamming Marlena.
Oh, big moonsault off the top. That should do it.
Oh, wait a minute now. Babu on the apron takes the attention away from the pinfall. Scorpio's got two hands of servant. Little miscommunication here from Asian royalty and manservant.
Position.
Uh-oh, and now Tiger hooks him. Neck breaker on Scorpio. Floats over, hooks the leg, two and three. This one is over.
By Tiger Ali Singh, and Tiger may be taking that momentum to Sunday Night Heat.
Live doing battle against Val Venus, the Pink Val Boski, certainly with issues with Terry Runnels on his mind. 4 hours of live action, folks, this Sunday night, beginning with Sunday Night Heat at 7, 6 Central, leading right into Survivor Series Deadly Game at 8 Eastern on pay-per-view. Tiger Ali Singh, your winner. Let's go to Slam Jam.
Everybody, what's up? Are you ready to kick it and get wicked with the WWF's Survivor Series Deadly Game? I hope so, because it is here this Sunday, 8 o'clock Eastern, 5 o'clock Pacific, live exclusively on pay-per-view from the sold-out Kiel Center in St. Louis, Missouri. And we are guaranteed to crown a new WWF champion, but that's not all. We will see the World Wrestling Federation Women's Championship on the line as the fully loaded Jacqueline will defend against the serious-minded challenge of the sexy, sultry Sable. In addition to that, the New Age Outlaws will defend the WWF Tag Team titles in a triple threat match against Mark Henry and D'Lo Brown and the Headbangers. But all eyes will be focused on the one-night single elimination tournament, guaranteed to crown a new WWF champion. Will it be The Undertaker? Kane? What about Ken Shamrock, the Intercontinental Champion? What about the former champion, Stone Cold Steve Austin?
Going into Survivor Series, it's kind of like a scene out of Cool Hand Luke, because Big Boss Man, what we have here is a failure to communicate. Just because you come in here as Vince McMahon's big bodyguard don't mean a damn thing to Stone Cold Steve Austin. New contract says I will get a championship shot, and there ain't no way that you're going to stand in front of me and defeat Stone Cold Steve Austin at Survivor Series, and that's all I got to say.
Now, if Stone Cold Steve Austin can get by the Big Boss Man, and that's a big if, he'll still have to win three more matches to regain the WWF title. And keep in mind, the Big Boss Man works under big orders from WWF owner Mr. McMahon. Kane and The Undertaker have a bye in the first round, but these two giants will collide in the second round. And has Kane been on a rampage or what? And The Rock is back in the Survivor Series Deadly Game Tournament by virtue of laying the smackdown on Mark Henry and Mr. McMahon. It's Survivor Series Deadly Game live on pay-per-view.
Still to come, Mark Henry hits rock bottom, courtesy of the people's champ, The Rock.
And up next, Stone Cold Steve Austin couldn't wait until Survivor Series to get his hands on the Big Boss Man.
Are you ready?
Welcome back, everybody, to another installment of the Totally Twister Game Center. I'm Michael Cole, and he's excellent. Hey, folks, George and Adam standing by to tell us all about Turbo Pass. Hit it, guys.
The object of the game is to complete as many passes as possible in a 2-minute time limit, and then you go home and
everybody George,
you
George,
happy.
George!
Just because you play the game fast doesn't mean you have to talk fast.
That was excellent. Speaking of excellent, Kai and Ty joining us now to play Turbo Pass in the game room.
Hands up, foot,
orange. Totally pizza.
Looks like there's a little problem with the translation. Well, join us next week. Jerry the King Lawler is going to be in the house to play Pass It. See you then.
Excellent. Want to play again?
Can you believe the price of popcorn?
It's a crime against humanity.
Everything costs an arm and a leg.
Yeah, not everything. You can get all your long-distance calls for under a buck.
He's talking about 10, 10, 220. Dial it and talk up to 20 minutes for only 99 cents.
You're very wise, tiny one.
Talk over 20 minutes, then what?
Yeah, and then what?
It's just 10 cents for each extra minute.
That's cheap. How is it possible? How does popcorn pop? Who cares?
Yeah, just dial 10, 10, 220 and talk up to 20 minutes for only 99 cents.
Bingo. You're not going to hurt me, are you, Norman?
I cannot wait to stomp out some of my new moves.
I'm gonna do a board slide into a 720 stale fish. You're gonna bust a rodeo flip off that kicker, man.
I'm gonna huck myself off that kicker into a 1260 Indie Grand.
Yeah?
Yeah!
Let's do it!
34 courses, 35 maneuvers, and thousands of combinations. Cool Borders 3 will put you right on the mountain. The rest is up to you.
Oh, that was Did you see that?
Classic arrow!
989 Studios.
I don't feel safe when I'm home alone.
When your safety is on the line, will you know how to react?
Don't take chances with your safety. I'm Terry Barr. Watch Fox 11 News for safety solutions. Tuesday at 6, we'll give you a situation and test you on a solution. Call Fox 11 News with your answer, and at 9, we'll find out if your answer is a safe one. Plus, an expert will show you why the solution is correct.
Watch Safety Solutions, Tuesday at 6 and 9.
Ready to party tonight? Hot, wild babes want to rock with you. Call 1-800-450-WILD. Call now and get a free hot sample. That's 1-800-450-WILD. Ready to take a walk on the wild side? Come on. Let's party. Call now.
Certainly, the supernatural forces of Kane could come to light once again this Sunday at Deadly Game.
Especially taking into consideration, Kevin, the fact that Kane is on his own. He doesn't have his father to guide him, nor his older brother, The Undertaker, to guide him.
With no moral compass in this man's life, there is no telling what Kane won't do at Survivor Series.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall in a 20-minute time limit, and it is for the World Wrestling Federation Light Heavyweight Championship. Introducing first, being accompanied to the ring by Brood members Gangrel and Edge, he weighs in at 207 pounds, the World Wrestling Federation Light Heavyweight Champion, Christian.
It'll be a rematch for Start a Fire. Who knows what that would have done?
It didn't end there, because from there, Kane went out into the audience. Kane choke-slammed a fan from the audience right to the floor.
He is out of control.
Being accompanied to the ring by Yamaguchi-san and Kaien-kai. From Japan, weighing in at 201 pounds, Taka Michinoku.
All the troops are assembled for Yamaguchi-san. I smell a title change right here, Bruce. I don't know about you.
I think that any member of Kaien-kai on any given day is worthy of being the WWF Light Heavyweight Champion.
Can you imagine, Bruce, what Kane would be like as the World Wrestling Federation Champion?
Well, we've already seen it. Kane is a former WWF champion.
Yeah, but then Paul Bearer was in charge. Now there's no one to guide him.
Kane definitely on his own and more dangerous than ever.
The Survivor Series Deadly Game, all those men competing for the biggest prize of them all. And you got to know, they are going to lay it all on the line this Sunday on pay-per-view. As we mentioned, Bruce, it's a rematch from Judgment Day. Christian surprised Taka. Is he going to be able to surprise him again?
I don't know. This time, Taka has all of his cohorts at Kaien-kai around ringside to help him out.
Yes, but Christian has Gangrel and Edge, the unified brood, outside the ring as well. Taka starts off very quick.
You know, Kevin, another thing, you talk about determination. Stone Cold Steve Austin wants nothing more than to get the gold around his waist one more time.
But are the odds too great for the Rattlesnake?
The odds aren't any greater than they are for anyone else in Deadly Game.
And at first lateral press of the match there, talking with the roll-up, but certainly having to face the big boss man, Mr. McMahon's hand-pointed assassin. I mean, that has just got to be an awesome challenge.
This boss man going out to defeat Stone Cold Steve Austin and become WWF champion, or is the boss man going out to injure Stone Cold Steve Austin and put Austin out?
I've got to wonder what Mr. McMahon's mindset is going to be. First, let's take a look at this double feature. The first near fall of the match, Bruce. Certainly, I think it's advantageous for Taka to get off to a quick start.
But he didn't, because Christian cut Taka short very quickly.
And now, look at this maneuver. Taking him down, the modified neck breaker. Hook in the leg, referee Jack Doan, two. Taka able to kick out, but certainly Mr. McMahon's mindset will come into question Sunday night on Heat Live, right before Survivor Series, Bruce. Hey,
exactly. We're going to find out, or maybe we won't find out, who the mystery opponent is for Mankind.
What do you think Mr. McMahon's going to say to The Rock?
I would have to believe that Mr. McMahon is very upset with The Rock. I think Mr. McMahon, just this past Monday, was very upset that The Rock defeated Mark Henry. Oh. And how upset is Mr. McMahon with his own son, Shane? Shane counted Mark Henry's shoulders down this past Monday.
We'll show you that later on.
Oh. Look out! Taken down on a tie-in tie.
Unbelievable agility there from the light heavyweight champion Christian, who is showing no ill effects of the gasoline-sponsored attack by Kane.
No, Christian just took out three members of Kayentai and almost took out their manager, Yamaguchi-san, in one fell swoop.
I spoke ill before. Tao was on the offside there and is able to put Taka perhaps in an offensive advantage now. Taka's going to the second rope. Wait a minute now. Taka's got to try to get some focus here. He hasn't had any as of yet.
Let's take a look at that dive that Christian did just moments ago, Kevin.
You'll see this taking down three members of Kayentai. And as we go back from the double feature, a near fall. Certainly, folks, Sunday Night Heat live at 7, 6 Central on the USA Network could answer many, many questions about what we'll see at Survivor Series Deadly Game.
It could also cause us to ask a lot more questions as well.
Look at this, tornado DDT out of the corner. Certainly Sable and Jacqueline with the women's championship at stake. Sable has been training intensely. What do you think her chances are against Jacqueline?
Well, I think that Jacqueline has the advantage here because Jacqueline is a more seasoned grappler and Sable is still a novice.
Wait a minute. Look at that move. That is absolutely devastating. And this one is over. What an impressive victory. And wait a minute now.
It's not over yet, Kevin.
It's Kayentai and the Brood.
And Edge sending Funaki over the top rope.
Gangrel, who take on Steve Blackman this Sunday on Heat, doing damage to Tao in the corner. And now, look out, Togo.
Togo's up.
Togo is down. Oh, wow. You feel the Brood gaining momentum, gaining strength and power.
This Sunday night, live on pay-per-view.
We are hours away from Survivor Series Deadly Game, where we will crown a new WWF champion. Guaranteed.
And still to come on Shotgun, Mark Barrow takes on the Godfather. And you know, if it ain't easy.
Oh, but up next, The Rock, the People's Champ, is on his way to Survivor Series. But first, he lays a smackdown on Mr. McMahon. You won't believe it. That's next.
This Thanksgiving, join the sweetest group of people you'll ever want to meet.
Shut up!
Save it for the show, okay?
I'm afraid you could wear my jacket. And I didn't say you could sleep with my husband. Hey, Linda Blair, spin your head around one more time. I'm going to give you exorcism.
Jerry Springer in Ringmaster.
So you dating anybody?
Rated R. Starts November 25th.
Say Spider-Man is like Castrol Syntec motor oil. And this is a harmful particle in your engine. Get the point? You see, Syntec's patented stabilizers seek out and neutralize harmful particles, protecting in ways other oils can't. Castrol Syntec, the active lubricant.
Let's rock. Who wants some?
Here's the 90s way to trim a beard. The 1890s. Today, there's the new Norelco Beard and Mustache Trimmer. With 9 adjustable settings, Norelco gives you the look you want. Norelco, put it to the test.
These folks are getting an actual free psychic reading, and you can, too.
She told me that I was raised by my grandmother.
Which way?
True.
She knew I was seeing two people, and I didn't even tell her that.
She knew I'd be starting a new job this week.
And it's true? You are starting a new job?
Monday morning.
She mentioned about a move to Europe, and that normally would have been outlandish, except for last week I accepted a position in Rome. So I'm moving to Europe.
He said that I was moving, changing addresses, going to Tallahassee, and that's where I'm going, Tallahassee.
He said Tallahassee?
To Tallahassee.
You're kidding.
No.
He actually nailed the city that you were moving to?
Nailed the city I was moving. going to. I didn't believe it at first. I've called before and it was a bunch of sucky ones, but this was cool.
It was just beautiful.
She gave you so much hope for the future.
Yeah.
Why is it making you cry?
It's so real. It felt so real.
The other ones are fake. This one is amazing. This one is good.
Call now for a free psychic reading and find out how to get $250 worth of free readings every month.
Call 1-800-516-7279.
Forever clear. Just your average band of losers and one-hit wonders.
You know, when I was a kid, it was always assumed that drugs were cool. I'd do any drug on the table. It didn't matter what it was. Man, I was wrong.
Never talk about the damage it's going to do to you physically and mentally.
It takes your life away from you. I threw away 14 years of my life. Sad. I used to be a stupid rock and roll cliche. Don't listen to me. Don't listen to anybody. Figure it out for yourself. I don't know what else to say.
We are back on Shotgun. Bruce Pritchard and Kevin Kelly. Marvelous Mark Merrill set to take on the Godfather. And along with Marvelous Mark is the women's champion. Will Jacqueline still have the belt after this Sunday?
I think another question is, will Jacqueline still be sporting Sable's ponytail as of this Sunday?
We know Sable will be on Heat, folks, at 7, 6 Central on the USA Network.
You can understand later on we're going to take a look at Sable training.
Easy now, easy. Sable's been training very hard
about it.
Sable's been training long and hard for this championship match. She says she's in the best shape of her life. Will it be enough to counteract the experience edge that Jacqueline will bring into this women's championship contest? All part of Survivor Series Deadly Game.
Well, just recently, Jacqueline got involved with some men when she slapped the Godfather.
That's right. This is a rematch from Heat, folks. And Jacqueline showed she was not shy about jumping up in the pimp business.
Well, it ain't easy.
His opponent.
But you know, the Godfather makes it look easy, Kevin.
Weighing 320 pounds, the Godfather.
Rolling in from Las Vegas. It's amazing how many, well, associates Godfather has throughout this country.
Well, the Godfather gets around and...
like you said,
sits right there on the back of his vest. If it ain't easy.
Of course, the Godfather, as we said, battled Marvelous Mark Merrill this past week on Sunday Night Heat. And this Sunday on Heat, folks, all the WWF superstars who will be competing in Survivor Series will be there live. Right before Deadly Game gets underway, St. Louis, the Kiel Center, it's totally sold out. And the best way for you to see all the action is live on pay-per-view. And remember, if you don't have pay-per-view capability, WWF.com is your backstage pass. That's your access, your way to get in. If you don't have pay-per-view, WWF.com.
I'm going to tell you something about WWF pay-per-view. We're going to give you all of the pay-per-view guaranteed. You will see a new WWF champion crown on pay-per-view this Sunday night.
All right, hold up.
Hold up, Kevin.
First of all, what do you think?
Well, since you're asking, not bad.
This isn't a dating game, Bruce.
It's just answering the Godfather.
Hey, you know what? I don't know if I should offer you the hose or offer yours a job.
Whoa! She's got a job. She's a women's champion.
Don't get mad now. Don't play a hate. Now listen, man.
Don't be a player hater.
If anybody, you should listen because you seem to have a lot of problems with hoes.
Interesting observation.
And you know what? Mine'll do what you say.
Oh, so look at that look from Jacqueline.
You have your choice, Mr. Merrill, of fighting me, knowing I'm gonna kick your ass.
Wow.
Or, wait a minute now, or here's the good part.
Part I was looking for.
You got your pick for a small fee, of course, of either one of these fine hoes for the whole night.
I wonder if Godfather could define this small
fee. Go ahead and look at her now.
It's negotiable. You want to give us a little insight on how this business transaction could take place?
I don't know, but I think Jacqueline's a little upset with Merrill even considering that deal.
Now, you see, that's your problem. You don't know how to treat a woman right. Just back away for a minute. You see, girl, what you need is a pimp like me running your life.
Now, he's looking to get slapped again. He's pushing his luck.
I know how to treat a girl right, and you know what? I know how to pop that thing.
Almero is the one doing the slapping. Can't say I blame him. Rather insulting comments. But Godfather quickly reversing it. And marvelous Mark Merrow now on the outside.
That Godfather follows right behind.
I think maybe the Godfather should maybe be a family counselor in his off hours. Oh! He seems to have real insight.
Well, Mark Merrow that time having some real insight into those solid steel steps.
He didn't take up the Godfather on his offer. Oh, look out! Women's champion! Riding bareback on the Godfather. Oh, no!
Oh, no.
Wait a minute now.
Uh-oh, Godfather having a little fun with Jacqueline.
A little love tap for the women's champion. We've got to get some order restored, please. Let's take a break.
They're big, bad, and bone crunching. They're WWF Bone Crunching Buddies. Listen to all the bone crunching attitude that is Stone Cold Steve Austin, Dude Love, Shawn Michaels, and The Undertaker. WWF Bone Crunching Buddies. They're bad to the bone.
In Risk, the world is your battlefield. You are the general, leading armies across borders, conquering everything in your path to take over not just a country, but the entire world. Risk, the game of global domination.
Down barrier, like a Harrier.
Grab Harrier.
Do a fly-by. Don't be so perplexed. Got me the rugged proportion of DMX.
I got moves in here underfoot. See, never mind. Others, if they don't mind me, I'm leaving the mark, showing individuality.
How's that new Reebok Run DMX 6 feel?
Banging, man.
Hey, hot, man.
You fellas gearing up for a 10K?
Action, there's foot action.
May I help you?
If I wanted a Whopper, no pickles, that wouldn't be a problem. But would we get to hear you sing?
No, sir. You get to hear us sing.
Hold the pickle, hold the lettuce, special order donuts.
May I help you?
If I want my value meal with rings
instead of fries,
is that a problem?
Value meal with rings or fries, it still costs a great price. You don't have to ask for twice to have it your way.
When you have it your way, it just tastes better.
There are the toys that rock your child's world. And then there are those other toys. Don't make costly mistakes with toys for your children this holiday season. Before you start your toy shopping, watch the Fox 11 Toy Test. Fox 11 found real kids to put real toys to the test. Find out which toys made the grade, which toys wimped out. As far as your child is concerned, this is the most important thing you may ever do. The Fox 11 Toy Test, all week on Fox 11 News at 5 and 10.
Ready to party tonight? Hot and wild babes want to rock with you. Call 1-800-450-WILD. Call now and get a free hot sample. That's 1-800-450-WILD. Ready to take a walk on the wild side? Come on. Let's party. Call now.
Shotgun, marvelous Mark Merrow, now carrying the fight to the Godfather. Lateral press, two count over. Certainly the Godfather had his ordeal outside with Jacqueline, the women's champion. Will Sable have the same type of problems with Jacqueline?
I said before, Jacqueline is the experienced wrestler of the two, but Sable's been training. It'll be interesting to see if her training pays off.
And now with the Sable charging through the arena, right before the pimp drop, once again, Jacqueline with a right hand across the Godfather's face.
In a blatant disqualification.
And now marvelous Mark going after the Godfather. Well, I'm telling you, this women's champion, she is brazen. Merrow getting out of harm's way.
Uh-oh, Jacqueline all alone with the Godfather in the ring.
Well, I would hope that the Godfather would remember that deep down inside, he is a gentleman.
The winner of this bout, as a result of the disqualification, the Godfather!
And a pin.
Certainly is. And folks, Sunday Night Heat, 7, 6 Central, all the superstars competing in Deadly Game will be there. You know Stone Cold is going to be in the house, as will the Boss Man.
Yes, he will. And also, The Rock, the People's Champ, will be there, as will Mr. McMahon, who is set to confront The Rock live on Heat.
Confronting The Rock, you know that he's got some plans for Stone Cold as well. What will Mr. McMahon attempt to do to his adversary? What's he going to do to Shane?
Who knows? We'll find out this Sunday night.
We got the last word on Survivor Series coming up after Slam Jam.
Hey, welcome back to WWF Slam Jam on this Survivor Series weekend. Now it is this Sunday, Survivor Series Deadly Game. 8 o'clock Eastern, 5 o'clock Pacific, live exclusively on pay-per-view from the sold-out Kiel Center in St. Louis, Missouri. 3 hours of unbelievable action, and guess what? All the action will be seen in that 3 hours. We're kind of pros at this. The WWF Women's Championship on the line. Jacqueline defending against Sable. The New Age Outlaws, Mark Henry and D'Lo Brown, and the Headbangers will battle in a triple threat match for the WWF Tag Team titles. But obviously, all eyes will be focused on the one night single elimination tournament guaranteed to crown a new WWF champion. Will it be The Undertaker, Kane, Ken Shamrock, Goldust, Stone Cold Steve Austin, The Boss Man? Who will win?
Survivor Series tournament for the WWF Championship.
Hey, get a grip. We've got to wrestle Jeff Jarrett, not Deborah McMichael.
One thing is for sure, Al Snow, you have f***ed me off for the last time, bringing your silly little head around.
Goldust, when you step in a ring with me, I'm going to break you.
Triple H, make no mistake about it. The best thing that ever happened to you was The Rock, and The Rock is the one that made your candy ass famous when he let you beat him for the Intercontinental title at SummerSlam.
Now I'm in the Survivor Series, but what's it really mean because Mr. Socko's gone?
Steve Austin, I'm kicking your ass.
Big Boss Man, what we have here is a failure to communicate. And there ain't no way that you're going to stand in front of me and defeat Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Kane, what do you think I will do to you if you stand before me at the Survivor Series?
What will you do to yourself if you blow this opportunity to find out who becomes the new WWF champion? Who's your favorite? Do you think it's The Rock? I heard Mr. McMahon's going to find him on Sunday Night Heat. Make sure you find Survivor Series on your TV in your home, live on pay-per-view this Sunday.
Up next, the sexy, sultry Sable is working out in preparation for her championship match at Survivor Series.
I'd like to show you something you're really going to like. 1010-9000. The only number you need to get directory assistance anywhere in America. It's the easiest way to find a phone number. You don't need to know the area code. Who can keep track of them? Just dial 1010-9000, tell the operator whose number you want and where they live. That's it. They find you the number, even offer to dial it for you with no connection charge. It's pretty simple, huh? I thought you'd like it. 1010-9000. Directory assistance for everyone in America.
The National Radon Test is about to begin. Radon enters your home from underground. A Harvard University report ranked radon number one in a list of home hazards. Computers give off radon. Windy days can increase radon levels in your home. Office of the Surgeon General strongly advises all homes be tested for radon. Rainstorms can produce higher levels of radon in your home. Radon is the second leading cause of lung cancer. You can call 1-800-SOS-RADON to find out how to get your family's home tested and made safer.
Catch Fox 11 online at www.wluk.com. From your home team, WLUK, Fox 11.
Fox 11 knows when severe weather will threaten your neighborhood, and we can tell you when and where it will hit with pinpoint accuracy. That means if you live near this neighborhood in Ashwaubenon, and Fox 11 can warn you 5 minutes sooner than any other Green Bay station.
First Track Live Doppler Radar. Every other television radar is last.
Live your fantasy tonight. Talk live one-on-one with exciting women. We'll talk about whatever you want. Private live action. Get your free hot sample. Call toll-free 1-800-7000-HOT. That's 1-800-7000-HOT. For your free hot sample, call toll-free now.
Pay-per-view is proudly presented by Nestle Crunch. It's just more fun to munch.
The WWF Women's Championship is on the line as Jacqueline defends a title against Sable, who has been training nonstop for her upcoming title match.
In addition to that great championship match, the tag team titles will be on the line. Triple threat style, the Outlaws have to contend against D'Lo Brown and Mark Henry and the Headbangers.
A new WWF champion will be crowned this Sunday night live on pay-per-view. Will it be The Undertaker or Kane, the People's Champ, The Rock, Stone Cold, or will it be McMahon's puppet, Mankind?
4 hours of live action begins with Sunday Night Heat at 7, 6 Central, and then Survivor Series at 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific. For Bruce, I'm Kevin. We'll see you this Sunday. Welcome everyone to Shotgun. Two Much is in the ring. Tag team action starts off this huge hour, a tumultuous week.
What does everybody want?
Scorpio have been winning a lot of matches as of late. A lot of people are surprised by that. You think that string continues?
Well, I'm surprised it even started, being there under the leadership of Al Snow.
What's wrong with Al?
He's a lunatic! Look at him!
With the top squad set to take out Too Much, we welcome you once again back to Shotgun. Along with Bruce's brother Tom, I'm Kevin Kelly. What a week it's been in the WWF. Not only, Tom, do we have a new WWF champion, but perhaps also a new hierarchy.
Well, Kevin, Team Corporate got even stronger this past week on Raw. We'll talk about that and a lot more in this hour.
And certainly, The Rock ascended to the throne of the World Wrestling Federation, winning the championship this past Sunday at Survivor Series, thanks in large part to Mr. McMahon.
Not the first time we've seen Mr. McMahon do something like that in a Survivor Series matchup, especially when it came to the WWF Championship.
How ironic. It's as if lightning struck in the same place twice. Of course, we're talking about how The Rock became the WWF Champion at Survivor Series. And we were all fooled, Tom, by the plot constructed by Mr. McMahon involving Shane, The Rock, and Vince McMahon himself. It couldn't have been more beautifully executed.
Everybody was fooled. We had the wool pulled over our eyes, the fans of the World Wrestling Federation, all the officials, the announcers. Nobody knew what was going to come to light except the Survivor Series. Everything happened right before our eyes.
Certainly did. Scorpio now with a head of steam. And I feel badly for Mankind in this, who really is an innocent victim. Thought he had found family in Mr. McMahon. What all he found was more disappointment. And now a great counter move by Christopher. Look at this. Tries the crucifix. Got him shoulders down. Just a two count.
And Kevin, what about Stone Cold? How disappointed must he be, especially being sucked in by Shane McMahon, being signed to a five-year contract, and then being screwed in Survivor Series?
Well, I think Stone Cold might be not disappointed, but might be angry, beyond angry. We'll talk about that and what exactly went down on Raw as well the night after Survivor Series a little later on.
Brian Christopher going for some consoling from his partner. Tag is made. First time we'll see Too Hot Scott Taylor.
Oh,
same result, though. Too Hot going flying. Tag made. Here comes Bob Holly. But certainly we know that Survivor Series was the beginning of Team Corporate, which we discovered the next night on Raw as Vince McMahon introduced his corporate champion, The Rock. Reversal now. Bob Holly put down. And certainly The Rock's comments extremely inflammatory towards the people that he once referred to as his own.
Yeah, the people's champion is now the corporate champion, but Stone Cold Steve Austin seemed to have another surprise up his sleeve the next night on Raw.
They certainly did. It led to an impromptu title match, and Team Corporate nearly lost its championship one night after it was earned at the Survivor Series.
Earned?
Yeah, well,
stolen, more like it.
We'll show you what went down on Raw this past week a little later on in the hour. As Scorpio now is sent across by Scott Taylor. And look at Brian Christopher trying with the distraction.
Good teamwork.
And now referee Tim White is going to do his best to try to restore some order. And we'll see if too much can mount some offense. But speaking of Team Corporate, what would be a team, Tom, without more players, namely Ken Shamrock?
Ken Shamrock proved to everyone in the World Wrestling Federation that he was definitely out for the money. And when it came to push or shove, Ken Shamrock said he's going with the corporate way. The people can take it and shove it.
Hard to believe that the... Oh, what a maneuver. Hard to imagine that the world's most dangerous man would actually go for the easy way. But I don't think Mr. McMahon is done. Made some overtures towards Sable. Actually, Shane McMahon did.
It seems to me that Team Corporate wants all the gold in their organization. He wants to get everybody. Mr. McMahon said he will beg, borrow, or steal whoever and whatever he needs to make Team Corporate the most powerful force in the World Wrestling Federation.
What exactly is going to be Mr. McMahon's next move? I know we will hear from Mr. McMahon this Sunday night on Heat. Tom, we understand that Mr. McMahon is going to make a shocking announcement, a major announcement about his power base in the WWF.
What could that be? I mean, could Shane get more stock, or could he have a little more power in the World Wrestling Federation?
That'll be this Sunday night on Heat, folks. We'll find out what Mr. McMahon's shocking major announcement is. Brian Christopher, off the top rope, nobody home. Wow, drove both knees down into the canvas, and this is Scorpio's opportunity to make a tag.
Well, Al Snow watching very carefully and closely on the outside of the ring at the Job Squad.
We will see Al in action a little later on against Tiger Ali Singh. Tag is made on both teams' parts. Plus, folks, we will also relive the tragic situation of Hawk this past week. Plus, we'll give you the latest update on his physical condition. And now Bob Holly with the boots of the midsection.
Watch this.
Pump handle slam coming up. Job Squad looking like they're going to victory once again. Power slam, incredible maneuver. Lateral press, hook of the leg. But too sexy Brian Christopher in to break it up with the count of two.
Good move.
Now all four men are in the ring. And let's see what happens here. Reversal now. Great agility there from Taylor. Rolling reverse. Referee not in position, though. Just whacked Scott Taylor with head. Tim White sees the cover and scores the three.
What does everybody want? Here are your winners, the Job Squad.
Watchful eye or helping hand.
Looks like it's a little helping head from Al Snow.
The Job Squad continues to win. Right now, let's go to the Slam Jam.
Hi, everybody. What's up? Welcome to WWF Slam Jam. The Job Squad keeps rolling on, and I guess you and I, the whole world, and 21,000 people in the Kiel Center last Sunday at Survivor Series are all part of the Sucker Squad because we were all duped by the evil genius, the master plan that was laid down by WWF owner Mr. McMahon, his son Shane, and, of course, Team Corporate. They pulled off the greatest double cross in WWF history. And now WWF owner Mr. McMahon has exactly what he wants, a corporate champion, and here he is, The Rock.
You know, at Survivor Series 1998, it should be called The Rock Series, the year of The Rock, because The Rock was the one who pulled off the biggest double cross in the history of sports entertainment. When The Rock put the sharpshooter... I'm sorry, when The Rock put the rock shooter on Mankind, The Rock, the first 10 rows, heard him and that stinking sock say, I quit, no more, Rock, please, you're the new champ. So now, as the fact remains, there is a reason why The Rock can go out in every arena and entertain 20,000 people, have them standing on their feet. There's a reason why The Rock gives the most electrifying interviews in sports entertainment today. There's a reason why The Rock makes $1 million a year, and that reason is simple. Is that The Rock raises his big right hand, he raises the people's, he raises the corporate eyebrow, and he lays the smack down on all the candy. If you smell what The Rock is cooking.
Well, The Rock talks a big game, and he can back it up. But The Rock definitely has some enemies right now. And who comes to mind? Stone Cold Steve Austin, the Sacrificial Lamb, Mankind, and The Undertaker. They all want a piece of this gold. But Rock, keep this in mind. Now you're lying in bed with the devils, you might get your own hell.
We'll see The Rock's first title defense as corporate champion against Stone Cold Steve Austin later on in the hour.
Plus, Taka Michinoku takes on D'Lo Brown coming up.
But up next, Hawk's dangerous ascent to the top of the Titantron this past Monday on Raw ended in tragedy. Stay with us.
Now you can bring all the high-flying, death-defying WWF attitude into your home with the WWF Catapult Live Action Ring. The only ring that comes with the deadliest weapons in wrestling, twin catapults. Catapult yourself straight to the top with the WWF Catapult Live Action Ring.
Dennis looks left and moves right. It's a masterful way touchdown.
I'm going to call Pete.
Hey, make sure you dial 10-10-3-2-1 first.
Why?
Because it saves me moolah.
Really?
Yeah, and it's half price for all calls over 20 minutes.
Half price? That's a lot.
What about monthly fees?
No fees, no hidden charges.
Here, look how low my phone bill is.
Wow, 10-10-3-2-1 does save a lot.
Don't bother calling.
Why not?
You just lost.
Dial 10-10-3-2-1.
Danger. Summon Musashi.
Great Fencer Musashi.
Action RPG. High maneuverability.
Great Fencer Musashi. Final Fantasy VIII. Playable demo included.
Find a four-leaf clover in November. It's easier to get your lawn rake for free. It's even easier to find parking at Lambeau on game day than it is to get tickets to a Packers game. You want those Packers tickets, but somehow they always seem just out of reach. Well, have we got news for you. Fox 11's Tom Milburn shows you that it is possible to get tickets and that it may be easier than you think. On News Extra, Monday and Tuesday on Fox 11 News at 9.
Ready to party tonight? Hot and wild babes want to rock with you. Call 1-800-5000-HOT. That's 1-800-5000-HOT. Take a walk on the wild side. Call now and get a free hot sample. Hot and wild babes want to party with you. Come on, get wild. Let's party. Call now.
We're back out shotgun. The Hardy Boys set to take on Farouk and Bradshaw in tag team action. And we first saw Farouk and Bradshaw as a team this past Sunday on Heat. Absolutely brutal in their attack on DOA. And Tom, I'm telling you, there's something that's just not quite right in the look of Bradshaw and Farouk.
May not look quite right, but they're walking to the ring with purpose right now, and I think the Hardy Boys have a look in their eye of not quite sure what they're going to do.
Can you say intimidated? I don't think I've ever seen Farouk and Bradshaw in better shape physically. Absolutely chiseled.
Well, I've got to wonder about their mental state right now.
Got to wonder about the mental state of Hawk. What drove him, folks, to the point of wanting to commit suicide last week on Raw? I mean, the emotional toll of watching a team like the Road Warriors, like the Legion of Doom, go down in flames as of late. And I know it was troubling to Hawk, but to get to that point...
Well, I think the troubles go far beyond just the breaking up of a tag team like the Legion of Doom. I think it's more personal. I think there's a lot of things we don't quite know about going on behind the scenes with Draws and Animal and Hawk.
Well, the good news is, folks, that Hawk will recover off the critical list, but we will hear from Animal and Draws this Sunday on Heat. And I'll be very anxious to hear what Hawk's best friend for over 20 years will say this Sunday. Jackal is...
on the stage looking down at this tag team match. Hardy Boys now, head of steam, crashing into Farouk, who was brutally beating Matt Hardy. And now fired across, caught, spine buster.
Man,
absolutely drove Jeff Hardy into the canvas. And the tag is made. Here comes Bradshaw into the ring, stepping over the top rope. It's a little different. I don't see the hook of horns anymore. Oh, boy.
No, but he sure is in the ring with purpose. And Jackal walking down the ringside. We've seen him in the locker room talking to different superstars. And I just wonder, I've got to wonder, what is the connection with Jackal coming out during Farouk and Bradshaw's match?
Bradshaw absolutely brutalizing Jeff Hardy in the corner. Irish whip across. Man, oh, man. Talk about a brutal beating. How about what Stone Cold Steve Austin suffered at the hands of The Undertaker this past Monday on Raw, Tom?
Well, we saw The Undertaker come in the ring at the end of the championship match with The Rock and Stone Cold and laid Stone Cold out with that shovel.
Was it Stone Cold Steve Austin's last chance at the WWF Championship? Did The Undertaker cost the Rattlesnake in his final opportunity at the gold? We'll show you what happened a little later on here in the hour. Farouk is back in, but the beating has not lessened. I mean, I'm thinking maybe referee Earl Hebner should consider stopping this contest.
Wow.
It's almost as if Jeff Hardy is walking unconscious right now.
Farouk, with a new purpose, it seems like, teaming with Bradshaw.
What are those markings on their chests?
Not quite sure.
And on their tights. Well, now Jeff Hardy
didn't even phase it.
Wow. Bradshaw just staring down at Jeff Hardy like some kind of piece of meat or something. Man. And now, scooping a slam. Bradshaw, head of steam. Jackal is still down at the apron. Close to the ring, and now the tag is made, thankfully. Matt Hardy off the top. Body.
Man.
Right into the awaiting arms of Bradshaw. Fall away slam.
Jackal looks pleased with what's going on in the ring right now.
I know that Jackal had had conversation with both Farouk and Bradshaw recently. You said that, Tom. Power slam.
But you know, I look in the eyes of Farouk right now, and it's almost like they're glassy.
Like there is no expression in those eyes. And now, off the tag, Bradshaw is in. Power bomb. Wait a minute. Oh, wow. Both Farouk and Bradshaw. The power bomb. This one finally is over. This is tough to watch. Oh, no. And now,
young Jeff Hardy taking a ride as well. The Jackal seems to enjoy this.
Barely. It's almost as if he's overcome with laughter.
Well, whatever's going on with Bradshaw and Farouk, it certainly seems to be working.
And while Bradshaw and Farouk show virtually no emotion, a man that is just filled with emotions, mostly sadness, is Mankind. We'll hear from him this Sunday on Heat. And another emotion, anger. Stone Cold Steve Austin, how about that?
The Rattlesnake is hot, and I would hate to be in his way when he wants to strike out and fight The Undertaker.
Got a feeling we'll hear more about that on Sunday Night Heat. But folks, still to come here on Shotgun, The Rock defends his newly won WWF Championship against The Rattlesnake.
And coming up next, we've seen the hit in one match already. Will he be involved in another? Al Snow meets the Tiger.
Are you ready?
Welcome back to the Totally Twister Game Center. Today, we'll be playing Pass It.
You know, Michael, Pass It is actually my favorite Totally Twister game.
What did you say?
Pass It. It's excellent. Excellent.
Well, I guess right now we'll go to George and Adam for an explanation.
The object of Pass It is to score as high as possible by passing Twister between players. But be careful, you only have a few seconds between each pass.
Oh, Adam, give me some love.
Give me a break, George.
I understand now that my partner, Grandmaster Robbie, is about to take on the King in Pass It.
All right, get in here, you hippie freak. And I'm warning you, you better keep up because I'm pretty good at this.
King, it's your turn. This is not excellent. King! King!
It's nice to see the King has his priorities straight. Until next time, I'm Michael Cole in the Totally Twister Game Center.
Wanna play again?
On December 4th, Norman Bates will be watching. Psycho. Rated R.
Wait to stomp us with my new moves.
I'm gonna do a board slide into a 720 stale fishing and I'll bust a rodeo flip off that kicker, man.
I'm gonna huck myself off that kicker into a 1260 Indy grab.
Yeah?
Yeah! Let's do it!
34 courses, 35 maneuvers, and thousands of combinations. Cool Borders 3 will put you right on the mountain. The rest is up to you.
Oh, yeah. That was sick! Did you see
that?
That
was sick air, bro!
989 Studios.
Today, people who didn't send the money Western Union and the heartbreak it caused.
You say your dog called?
Yeah, said he needed tuition money for obedience school.
That's amazing.
No, he's always asking for money for something. Prima donna.
What did you do?
I sent it.
But not Western Union?
No. They never treated me special.
So it never got there?
No. But that's not the worst part.
It's not?
No. Now he turned the cat against me.
Uh-huh.
Hey, it's your money. Use Western Union, the fastest way to send money worldwide.
Fox 11 wants to keep you and your family safe. That's why we're promoting the use of trigger locks in all guns kept in your home. Join Fox 11 and these sponsors with your financial support for the Green Bay Police Department and the Hunter Safety Instructor's efforts to supply 1,500 trigger locks at no charge to anyone who owns a gun. Send your contributions to the address listed on the screen. Helping to keep your family safe is why Fox 11 is your home team.
Live your fantasy tonight. Talk live one-on-one with exciting women. We'll talk about whatever you want. Private live action. Get your free hot sample. Call toll-free 1-800-7000-HOT. That's 1-800-7000-HOT. For your free hot sample, call toll-free now.
And StoneCold.com is buzzing about what perhaps was Stone Cold's final opportunity at the WWF Championship. Welcome back to Shotgun, everybody.
The following contest is scheduled for one fall with a 20-minute time limit. Entering the ring, accompanied by Bamboo from the continent of Asia, weighing 274 pounds, Tiger Ali Singh.
Of course, Tiger Ali Singh, Asian royalty with Babu. My Babu, of course, Bruce, your brother, on assignment. Happy to have you here with us, Tom.
He threw roses at you too, didn't he?
Hardly.
What does everybody want?
His opponent from Lima, Ohio, weighing 286 pounds, Al Snow.
Al Snow rejoining us here in the hour on Shotgun. And earlier, Tom, Head, very successful in helping the Job Squad to victory.
Well, anything you can get to get a victory here with the Job Squad is an asset. Now Snow is their leader, so to speak, has been very successful for Bob, Holly, and Scorpio.
So will Al Snow get ahead when he battles Tiger Ali Singh? It's amazing that the fans have taken to an absolute stark raving lunatic. Believes he hears voices coming out of that mannequin head.
Well, I believe I hear voices coming out of that mannequin head too, sitting over there in the...
Hey, wait a minute, come on.
What?
So Tiger Ali Singh got a 40-pound weight advantage on Al Snow.
Sweep out that ring. Sorry.
Well, Tiger refuses to compete unless there are rose petals scattered across the canvas. He is royalty, you know. Hip toss.
Whoa!
Really sent Tiger Ali Singh flying. I'm a little surprised that Tiger is wanting to soil the royal hands. I'm surprised he's not sending Babu into battle as he's done in the past.
Tiger Ali has a lot of ability. He's a tremendous athlete. I think he's going to have to get in there and show it eventually, and this is a good match to do it.
Al Snow now ducks through the clothesline. Great counter move. Face first to the mat goes Tiger. Of course, Tiger Ali Singh reminds a lot of people of The Rock. The arrogance, the cockiness, the confidence, and now the corporate champion. Vince McMahon's number one prize basically has the world on a string.
as well he should. The Rock is the youngest World Wrestling Federation champion of all time, and he is on a roll that is just going to keep getting bigger and bigger.
And then this past Monday, The Rock's ride almost came to an abrupt end when he battled Stone Cold Steve Austin. And folks, we will show you action from this colossal championship match later on in the hour. In case you missed it, we'll show it here to you on Shotgun. Tiger Ali Singh fires in, and you gotta wonder if Stone Cold Steve Austin, if not for the outside interference, would Austin have walked away with the championship?
As tough as Stone Cold is, even he couldn't battle four or five men. And yes, I've got to wonder, he might have walked out the champion again, but Mr. McMahon wants to make sure his corporate champion, The Rock, stays that way.
And what a way to keep the corporate champion happy by naming the next WWF Spectacular after him. It's Rock Bottom, December 13th, from the already sold-out General Motors place in Vancouver, British Columbia. A beautiful facility. Can't wait to get back there.
And fans are clamoring to WWF events. Over 40,000 people were in attendance on Sunday and Monday alone last week.
Boy, and the intensity inside the Rupp Arena, folks. You'll be able to relive it in just a few moments when we show you what happened in the WWF Championship match between The Rock and Stone Cold Steve Austin. You won't believe it. Al Snow now with Tiger Ali Singh in the corner. Some back elbows to free himself. Once again, the slide tactic. And another attempt at some offense. Oh, wow. Big spin kick. Takes Tiger Ali Singh down.
Gotta wonder if Al can hear the voices from the head all the way in the middle of the ring.
Certainly, head has helped Al Snow's career.
Boom.
Tiger Ali Singh takes... Look at Al. I mean, every time he gets struck with an offensive maneuver, it's as if he's laughing.
He might just be delirious.
I think that's a given. So wait a minute, now Tiger is gesturing at Babu to go over and get in the same corner as the head. Slugfest now, what's Babu doing down here?
Looks like he might be making a move for the head.
Al now fires Tiger across, misses with the clothesline. Oh. Double clothesline, both men down, Babu's got head.
Is he talking to it too or what?
He looks nervous.
Well, I'd be nervous too if I had that thing in my hand.
And I'm wondering what Babu has plans for this. Al Snow first up to his feet. Oh, Al hates it when people touch head. He is closing in on Babu. Oh, wow. Babu pays for his sins. And now, referee Mike Chioda getting Babu down off the apron. Uh-oh, for the second time, head strikes. The KO, two, and this one is over.
Somebody has got to do something about Al Snow's head.
I don't think Al Snow can do anything about it. He's a lunatic.
You can say that again.
Folks, let's go to Slam Jam.
Welcome back, everybody, to WWF Slam Jam. We are all still reeling, still trying to digest this master plan that was laid down by WWF owner Mr. McMahon at Survivor Series. And obviously, an elaborate scheme like this took months of planning. And of course, a scheme like this leaves victims. And the one that comes to mind is the poor, gullible mankind. I mean, think about it. Mr. McMahon told mankind, I think of you like a son. He gave him the WWF Hardcore Championship. He gave him a patsy in the first round of the Deadly Game Tournament, Dwayne Gill. But it was mankind that was destroyed mentally and physically. A couple of days ago, our cameras caught up with Mick Foley.
Well, Vince McMahon exploited my trust and made me basically look like a complete idiot. Well, tra-la-la, boom, D.A. Vince, you win the prize. Or didn't you get it? I already looked like an idiot. I carry around a piece of crap like this. I wear a stupid mask and I wear a sock on my hand, Vince. But you had to go one more. I can forgive you for almost anything except this, Vince. You made me wear this shoe! And as a result, well, I'm gonna find a special place to stick this shoe, and I don't think you're gonna like it. Where might that place be, Mankind? Use your imagination.
Mm-mm-mm. Well, Mankind may get his opportunity for revenge against Mr. McMahon this Sunday on Sunday Night Heat, because Mankind is scheduled to elaborate on this double cross, and get this. WWF owner Mr. McMahon will also be on Sunday Night Heat because he has a major announcement. That doesn't take a rocket scientist to connect the dots and figure out the sparks are going to fly. Make sure you check out Sunday Night Heat this Sunday on the USA Network, 7 o'clock, 6 Central.
Still to come on Shotgun, D'Lo Brown steps into the ring, shaking his head with high-flying Takamichinoku.
But coming up next, The Rock looks to lay the smackdown on the rattlesnake. Stay tuned.
Their offense is offensive. As for their defense,
we got two words for you.
There's no defending them. And with this team of degenerates throw on their game jerseys, you can always count on a penalty for unnecessary roughness. The exclusive DX football jersey. To get yours, call 815-734-1161. Log on to the WWF Shop Zone website or send a check or money order to the address on your screen. The jersey costs $39.99 plus $9 shipping and handling. Get with the program. Order now.
If they ruined your world, forced your people into slavery, tortured you for your tears, made brew out of your bones, you'd pray for a hero too. But sometimes you take what you can get. It's time to save Oddworld again.
Here at VMI, we were asked to try the new Norelco Advantage for 21 days. That was quiet dissension.
I'm not giving out my blade.
And anxious inquiry.
The heck is this? Goo?
But then we started to realize the lotion actually gave us a closer, smoother shave than we expected. Without the nicks and cuts like blades, our fear diminished. Our hopes arose, and life got a little less hairy.
Come on, baby face, move it!
The new Norelco Advantage. Put it to the test. If you don't like it, they'll give you your money back, guaranteed.
There's only one hero who possesses the strength, the skill, and the courage to save the world single-handedly. Glover! Strength? Glover's got the magic and the moves to mash big bad bosses. Skill? Glover's got the brains to solve mind-boggling puzzles. And talk about courage? Glover's got the to handle any challenge. Glover! For Nintendo 64 and PC CD-ROM, gotta love the glove.
The 1999 WeatherFriend calendars are here, back with daily normal and record temps and more room to write down your weather observations. Plus, a South Central and Northern Wisconsin nature calendar and a journal of your field notes. The WeatherFriend makes a great Christmas gift. Proceeds benefit the Northeast Wisconsin Audubon Society. To order your 99 WeatherFriend calendar, send $5 check or money order to the address on your screen or stop by here at Fox 11.
Ready to party tonight? Hot and wild babes want to rock with you. Call 1-800-5000-HOT. That's 1-800-5000-HOT. Take a walk on the wild side. Call now and get a free hot sample. Hot and wild babes want to party with you. Come on, get wild. Let's party. Call now.
WWF Rock Bottom, in your house, live December 13th from the sold-out General Motors Place in Vancouver, British Columbia, is presented by Glover. New on Nintendo 64, gotta love the glove.
The following contest is scheduled for one call with a 20-minute time limit. Introducing first, accompanied by Kayan Kai members, Yamaguchi-san, Funaki, Heyo, and Togo, from Japan, weighing 187 pounds. Takamichinoku!
Takamichinoku set for action against D'Lo Brown. But what about the championship match from Raw last Monday? Stone Cold Steve Austin may have seen his last title opportunity slip through his grasp because of The Undertaker.
And Kevin, you've got to wonder if The Undertaker did this intentionally to try and rob Stone Cold of the WWF Championship.
Certainly hasn't lessened, despite the fact that D'Lo and Mark Henry did not walk away from Survivor Series, the WWF Tag Team Champions. But I know that Mark Henry's heart has got to be swelling with pride after he made an offer to China.
Well, last Monday on Raw, China showed up during Mark's match against Val Venus, and all he wanted was a date. And China obviously is still his love interest here in the World Wrestling Federation. I've got to wonder if China is actually going to go on a date with Mark Henry.
The way Mark said it, all the legal problems will go away if she goes out with him on just a date.
He said, just a date, no sex, nothing else. Just go have dinner with me, and that's all it is.
Well, is this just some kind of ploy? I mean, really, do you think Mark Henry truly has feelings for China?
Come on, I think he's smitten with China. I think he's in love. Love is in
really?
The air. Come on, Kevin.
Well, I know the poetry certainly appears to be sincere, and I just wonder what China thinks of this entire situation.
It brought a tear to my eye.
Irish whip hard to the buckle goes Taka, and you can already see how D'Lo, with about an 80-pound weight advantage, is really using it.
Well, Taka Michinoku is used to wrestling men bigger than him. I mean, he's a light heavyweight, but he doesn't mind mixing it up with heavyweights anytime.
And once again, another Irish whip attempt to the corner, but this time Taka with the counter. Up to the top rope, D'Lo not paying attention. Missile drop kick.
He's got to use moves like that against a bigger guy like D'Lo. Good hurricanrana.
And now Taka building up ahead of Steve going across. Oh. Double clutch there, and that might have cost him. And now D'Lo out on the floor after Taka.
Oh,
just throw it all right. Right out in front of us, Tom.
Doesn't want to get counted out here.
Referee laying the count on. Watch out, man. Home. Shoulder first to the post outside. Taka now up on the apron. Look
out!
Right in our laps! And Taka, not wanting to be viewed as an underdog in this contest, carrying the fight to D'Lo Brown.
I don't think he cares how big this guy is. He wants to get in there and show everybody that he has just as big a heart, if not bigger.
And now trying the vertical suplex. D'Lo, the counter.
Oh, look out!
We have got to take a break. This incredible match continues. Stay with us.
So, Chris, have you ever had trouble finding someone's phone number?
Oh, yeah, especially when I don't know the area code.
Well, you're going to love 1010-9000, the only number you need for directory assistance.
Now, how's it work?
Just dial 1010-9000, tell the operator whose number you want and where they live. That's all there is to it.
Sounds easy.
They'll even dial it for you with no connection charge.
They thought of everything.
It was my idea. 1010-9000, directory assistance for everyone in America.
The national radon test is about to begin. Radon enters your home from underground. A Harvard University report ranked radon number one in a list of home hazards. Computers give off radon. Windy days can increase radon levels in your home. Office of the Surgeon General strongly advises all homes be tested for radon. Rainstorms can produce higher levels of radon in your home. Radon is the second leading cause of lung cancer. You can call 1-800-SOS-RADON to find out how to get your family's home tested and made safer.
These folks are getting an actual free psychic reading, and you can too.
She told me that I was raised by my grandmother.
Which way?
True.
She knew I was seeing two people, and I didn't even tell her that.
She knew I'd be starting a new job this week.
And it's true? You are starting a new job?
Monday morning.
She mentioned about a move to Europe, and that normally would have been outlandish, except for last week I accepted a position in Rome. So I'm moving to Europe.
He said that I was moving, changing addresses, going to Tallahassee, and that's where I'm going, Tallahassee.
He said Tallahassee?
To Tallahassee.
You're kidding.
No.
He actually nailed the city that you were moving to?
He nailed the city I was moving to. I didn't believe it at first. I've called before and it was a bunch of sucky ones, but this was cool.
It was just beautiful. She gave you so much hope for the future.
Yeah.
Why is it making you cry?
It's so real. It felt so real. The other ones are fake. This one is amazing. This one is good.
Call now for a free psychic reading and find out how to get $250 worth of free readings every month.
Call 1-800-516-7279.
Welcome back to Shotgun, everybody. D'Lo Brown with the offensive advantage now on Takamichi Noku. Setting up. Look at this. Running powerbomb. That should do it. Taka is hurt. Let's take a look at what just happened a minute ago before we went to break. Taka was suplexed on the outside, right on the floor by D'Lo Brown. And I don't believe Taka's recovered yet. He went down hard on his hip as well. When he did the acai moonsault on our table, lateral press two, and that would have been three, but Taka smartly puts a right leg on the bottom rope.
I believe Taka's hurt, and Taka better muster up an offense quickly or else D'Lo Brown is going to put this match away.
I'm wondering if D'Lo is going to look to end things here with the lowdown. Perhaps not yet. Up to the second strand this time. Oh! Down with a forearm right across the chest. Lateral press on Taka, but come on, D'Lo.
That could cost D'Lo right there. That's a big mistake if you ask me.
Folks, Sunday Night Heat, this Sunday at 7, 6 Central on the USA Network. We all await to hear what Mr. McMahon is having described as a shocking major announcement about his power base in the WWF. Speculation abound about what Mr. McMahon has planned for this Sunday.
And we'll also hear from Mankind as well about what happened at Survivor Series.
Look at Taka on the top rope, tornado DDT. Taka Michinoku with a desperation-like maneuver. Now going to the top. This could be his only offensive chance.
Whoa, man!
Beautiful hurricane run off the top rope. And now Taka quickening the pace.
Oh.
D'Lo elevates him over the top rope.
He hit his hip on that apron and he came in.
Henry, 400 pounds of splash on the far side. Man, oh man.
I would be surprised to see Taka recover from this one. He is hurt.
And now D'Lo Brown, look at this, the sky high. And this one is over.
Here is your winner, D'Lo Brown.
And now, wait a minute, Kai and Tai coming in. Looking for revenge. Uh-oh. Funaki hung out to dry.
Oh, no!
Big power slam. Look at D'Lo.
Oh, man.
The lowdown. How about that for emphatic? Folks, this Sunday on Sunday Night Heat, we will hear from Mr. McMahon. Plus, we'll also see Ken Shamrock in action.
The Intercontinental Champion will face Val Venus in a big matchup. And also, I understand the big boss man will be in action.
It's all going to happen this Sunday on Heat, folks. Thanks for joining us on Shotgun.
He's on.
What can I say? I mean, let's face facts. Some people, people like us, we're just born naughty. Because now, you've made an enemy out of me.
No! No!
Richtig zur Sache, Reno Riggins und Steven Dunn gehen sofort los auf die Hardy Boys. Und Reno Riggins, der Mann mit dem dunklen Haar, und Steven Dunn, der Blonde. Und dieser Steven Dunn, Günther, der dürfte ja für uns alle eigentlich auch kein Unbekannter sein.
Ja, auch Reno Riggins kennen wir aus einigen Auftritten. Bin auch nicht so beeindruckend, aber... Die Jungs in der Tat sind nicht ganz neu, sind wohl ein bisschen länger jetzt zur Schule gegangen, zur Wrestling-Schule.
Ja, Reno Riggins war ja oft und gern gesehener Gast, hat aber auch meistens immer nur die Kraft der Gegner zu spüren bekommen. Während Steven Dunn ja nun lange Zeit ein Teil von Well Done war, ein doch relativ gutes Tag Team hier in der Federation, haben es natürlich auch nie ganz nach oben gebracht, aber hatten durchaus ihre Chancen und waren eigentlich relativ lange dabei.
Ja, waren auch ganz nett anzusehen, da hat man also technisch einiges erkennen können, aber ob sich das verbessert oder verschlechtert hat, momentan ist davon noch nichts zu sehen, denn die Hardy Boys eindeutig überlegen.
Eine wunderbare Aktion hier von Jeff Hardy, das Cover hinterher, aber Reno Riggins und Steve Dunn, wie gesagt, zwei absolute Altmeister, kann man fast sagen, können, aber darf die also auf keinen Fall unterschätzen, auch wenn sie jetzt lange pausiert haben beide, aber sie sind doch noch beide einigermaßen körperlich fit und könnten hier durchaus eine scharfe Klinge schlagen.
Ja, er greift noch mal kurz ein von außen, Steven Dunn. Reno Riggins, ja auch er hat offensichtlich relativ viel im Kraftraum trainiert, zusätzlich zu den Technikübungen, die ja anstehen bei der Ausbildung. Und das zeigt sich hier, die Kraft hat er und die Technik stimmt jetzt auch. Power Slam von ihm.
Ja, dann ein etwas legeres Cover, das konnte natürlich nicht zum Erfolg führen. Auch wenn er sich da auch noch beschwert, dass der gute Tim White noch schneller erzählen sollte. Und ein Snapmare.
Ja, die Amano noch mal den Griff auf, nur in der erlaubten Art und Weise anzusetzen. Ja, so kann man einen Jeff Hardy natürlich nicht in die Knie zwingen. Dazu hat er auch zu wenig Kraft.
Ja, aber dann dieser verdeckte Faustschlag, das wirkt dann schon eher. Dann kommt Reno Riggins angestürmt, aber Jeff bekommt das Bein nach oben, das Ganze gleich zwei miteinander. Und dann taucht Jeff Hardy ab und Reno Riggins fliegt ins Leere, hier im Besonderen auf den Ringposten.
Ja, da eigentlich ganz gut begonnen, die Aktionsfolge, Reno Riggins aber dann einmal verschätzt und schon geht das Ganze nach hinten los. Der Wechsel, Steven Dunn kommt herein und auf der anderen Seite gelingt dann doch noch der Wechsel, also Matt Hardy jetzt im Ring. Nimmt es auch gleich mit beiden auf.
Ja, der wirbelt ganz gut los, der gute Matt. Und dann ist auch Jeff wieder da. Jetzt haben sie beide Kontrahenten in der Ringecke, aber Reversal und die Hardy Boys knallen mit voller Wucht gegeneinander.
Gegen beide das Reversal gelungen. Also Steven Dunn und Reno Riggins, ich denke, die haben schon das ein oder andere Mal zusammen trainiert. Und von alleine kommt ja so eine Aktion nicht. Und auch die gemeinsame Kleidung spricht also für weitere Auftritte.
Und dann kommt aber Matt angeflogen und er rollt Steven allein und bringt das Cover durch. Also der Sieg für die Hardy Boys, aber bei den Jungs Steven Dunn und Reno Riggins sollte man sich vormerken. Auf jeden Fall ein guter Frühstein für auch andere Tag Teams hier in der Federation.
Ja, den Blue Blazer werden wir gleich sehen gegen Taka Michinoku.
His opponent from Punk Unknown, weighing 222 pounds, the Blue Blazer.
Der Blue Blazer kann nicht Owen Hart sein.
Aber oder es gibt mehrere, denn also bei diesem Einzug und auch die Figur würde ich erneut sagen, das ist Owen Hart. Aber
das würde ich auch sagen, denn auch der Mund und die Bewegung, du hast vollkommen recht, das ist für mich auch Owen Hart. Also entweder, ja natürlich ist das Owen, das siehst du schon in der Körperhaltung. Also für mich spielt Owen da irgendein Spielchen. Und er hatte halt so den einen oder anderen Verbündeten, der ab und zu mal in die Kluft des Blue Blazers schlüpft. Aber Owen hat ja damals schon gesagt, er möchte eigentlich nicht mehr in den Ring steigen. Und so tut er es, nur mit einer anderen Identität, in der ihn keiner erkennen kann.
Da hat er sich fast selbst eine Falle gestellt. immer aufs Seil geht, aber Taka Michinoku ist da auch erfahren genug. Wird jetzt allerdings von Owen Blazer, Schrägstrich, Fragezeichen, wie auch immer. Ja, gut, für mich jetzt, ist auch Owen.
Nein, jetzt ist es klar, jetzt eben wie er gejubelt hat, das ist nur Owen. Da hat er sich selber verraten, wirklich.
Ja, hat auch den Umhang ausgezogen. Das hat ja der andere Blue Blazer nicht gemacht. Oder die anderen. Auch das ist ja möglich, dass er mehrere hat, die ihn da vertreten. Um vielleicht die Verwirrung noch kompletter zu gestalten.
Ja, der wirbelt ja auch ziemlich los. Und jetzt kommt der typische Owensche Enjigiri. Und diese Jubelpose, da gibt es einfach keinen anderen. Das Cover. Aber stimmt schon, zum vierten oder fünften Mal kommt Taka hier aus dem Cover wieder heraus. Aber bisher kam er noch nicht dazu, selber Aktionen anzusetzen.
Vielleicht jetzt. So, ein Spin-Kick zumindest, mit dem er durchkommt. Er versucht zuzuschlagen, aber das ist nicht seine Domäne.
Ja, jetzt will Taka ihm die Maske abziehen und das gelingen wird. Nein, nicht ganz. Dann hätten wir endgültig Klarheit gehabt. Aber so bleibt das Gesicht von Owen noch ein wenig im Verborgenen.
Ja, das darf natürlich nicht passieren, denn das ist ja das, was er uns weismachen will. Damit sicher auch den Offiziellen, den Fans, dass Blue Blazer eben nicht Owen Hart ist. Wozu er auch immer das Ganze dann verwenden will, vielleicht mal so bei einem Titelmatch sich dann einwechseln, was auch immer. Da gibt es ja verschiedene Möglichkeiten. Es ist nie von Schaden, wenn man über die wahre Identität die Leute im Unklaren lässt. Jetzt holt er doch seinen Umhang wieder.
Zieht ihn sich wieder an. Anscheinend will er jetzt schon gehen oder er hat fertig. Nein, er geht aufs oberste Seil.
Er braucht die Flügel.
Ja, Taka kommt wieder auf die Beine. In der Tat. Wieder Ikarus kommt er angeflogen.
Das ist der Zaubermantel, ganz offensichtlich. Mit dem geht alles leichter und besser.
So, jetzt das Ganze nochmal. Ja, da flattert er schon ein bisschen. Und aber Taka rollt ihn ein. Und das war ganz, ganz knapp.
Da wäre es fast so weit gewesen, der Überraschungsangriff von Taka Michinoku. Und jetzt ist er natürlich ein bisschen eingeschränkt in der Beweglichkeit. Blue Blazer. Arme nach oben reißen, das geht natürlich noch. Und jetzt fliegt er wieder, wohin auch immer.
Ja, da ist aber nur knapp einem Überraschungssieg durch Taka entgangen. Der Whipping in die Ringecke und dann kommt der Blue Blazer angeflogen, aber Taka bringt das Knie nach oben. Und der DDT, der Swinging DDT von Taka, das Cover. Und wieder kommt der Blue Blazer heraus.
Also Taka versucht hier wirklich alles. Wäre für ihn natürlich ein sehr, sehr schöner Erfolg. Auch das ist klar. Jetzt ein Spinning Reverse Kick von ihm.
Auch wenn er eigentlich gar nicht weiß, gegen wen er diesen Erfolg erringen würde. Aber immerhin ein schöner Erfolg.
Und ein wunderbarer Launching Clothesline Moonsault von ihm.
Ja, dann veräfft er den Blue Blazer noch ein bisschen. Bringt ihn zurück in den Ring.
Er will jetzt ganz offensichtlich den Michinoku Driver ansetzen.
That's it, sagt er. Das war's. Auf Englisch-Japanisch gemischt. Da kommt er angeflogen mit dem Flying Dropkick. Der geht ins Leere. Und jetzt kommt der Sharpshooter. Und wer mag das wohl sein, der den Sharpshooter als Finishing Move ansetzt?
Ja, können Sie selber erraten. Und wir sehen noch D'Lo und Mark Henry gegen die D.O.
Do you smell what The Rock is cooking? Do you want to be a big shot?
Yes, the new World Wrestling Federation champion.
The people's champ, The Rock goes in the people's ring. Shot the people's elbow.
You got a little itch for The Rock, then you go ahead and scratch it.
Jetzt will er Mankind eine um die Ohren donnern.
In your house, Rock Bottom, demnächst auf DSF Action.
Rock says, know your damn role.
Introducing first, accompanied by Paul Emmering at a combined weight of 605 pounds, Eight Pullman Skull, the Disciples of
gentlemen.
Fans wissen, was Dido hören will, nachdem Rocky in der Nation nicht mehr dabei ist. Die sowieso sehr klein geworden. Goldfarben haben wir auch schon lange nicht mehr gesehen, zumindest nicht in dieser Formation. Aber sie lassen sich immer noch als Nation zumindest filmisch ankündigen. Dido und Mark Henry, die beiden Vertreter. Und auf der anderen Seite DOA mit Cole Ellering, der seine Maschine am Gang abgestellt, aber Mark Henry hat sie dann doch zufrieden gelassen.
Ja, und mit 8-Ball natürlich, den wir hier im Ring sehen, gegen Dilo und Skull. Und jetzt in Gottphase kann man nur sagen, der ist mit Sicherheit nicht mehr Mitglied der Nation. Der hat ja nun wirklich ganz andere Kapitel aufgeschlagen. Bezeichnet sich selber als Luden oder Zuhälter. Und ist auch stolz darauf. Ist ja auch ein lauterer Beruf. Und kommt dann auch immer mit seinen Damen in den Ring. Und stellt seine Gegner dann immer vor die Wahl. Wollen sie lieber gleich gar nicht erst das Match antreten oder soll er es wirklich tun, ihm den Hintern zu versohlen? Also das jetzt so in etwa die Tour vom Godfather, aber leider haben wir ihn nicht allzu oft gesehen in letzter Zeit.
Ja, vielleicht muss er sich mehr um sein anderes Geschäft kümmern, wie auch immer. Er hat also eine neue Familie, eine neue Aufgabe gefunden. Wenn er meint, dass ihm das besser zusteht. Aber ich denke, dass Dilo und Mark Henry sich vielleicht mal einen Tag-Team-Namen suchen sollten. Der Frosch und das Monster oder irgend sowas.
Das wäre nett. Oder der Kämpfer und der Verliebte zum Beispiel. Denn also eins ist ja inzwischen klar geworden. Wenn China hier irgendwo auftaucht in der Halle, dann haben die beiden das Match und egal gegen wen verloren. Wenn sie das nicht tun, dann haben sie durchaus eine Chance auch zu gewinnen.
Zumindest wenn Mark Henry im Ring ist zu diesem Zeitpunkt. Ansonsten müsste dann Dilo alleine weitermachen. Also China hat ja gesagt. Jetzt hoffen wir natürlich, dass wir ein bisschen was mitbekommen von dem Treffen, wenn es denn stattfindet. Oh, Paul Ellering greift auch selbst aktiv ein.
Ja, auch Edball hilft dann noch ein bisschen mit dem Fuß nach. Während Skull jetzt wieder sich den guten Mark Henry schnappt. Oh, aber dann muss er diesen Clothesline hinnehmen.
Der hat gesessen. Dilo kommt da rein. Arbeiten nach wie vor gut zusammen, Dilo und Mark Henry. Das ist auch für so ein erfahrenes und eingespieltes Tag Team natürlich die Disciples of Apocalypse schwierig.
Ja, und Skull muss jetzt ganz schön einstecken. Hier von Dilo.
Die World Wrestling Federation Hotline 0190 9044. Hier gibt es weitere Hintergründe zu den Sendungen der World Wrestling Federation. Weitere Entwicklungen, Dinge, die sich erst nach den Sendungen abgespielt haben. Außerdem jede Menge Porträts der World Wrestling Federation Superstars und auch so einige Gerüchte, an denen sicher einiges dran sein dürfte. Die World Wrestling Federation Hotline 0190 9044.
Ja, da sind wir wieder nach einer kleinen Unterbrechung. Dilo mit dem Cover. Jetzt ist 8-Ball wieder im Ring. Also die beiden haben wohl gewechselt. Jetzt auch der Wechsel bei den anderen beiden. Also Mark Henry, jetzt der Mann im Ring. Der Leg Drop eingesprungen. Das Cover hinterher.
Ein geschickter Wechsel war das von D'Lo, der einfach selbst in die Hände klatscht.
Ja, da habe ich mich natürlich verguckt. Natürlich ist es nicht 8-Ball im Ring, sondern Skull nach wie vor. 8-Ball nach wie vor draußen. Also wir haben wirklich nur einen ganz kleinen, kurzen Sprung eben gehabt.
Geht sozusagen nahtlos weiter. Ja, das, so kann es nicht funktionieren. Da ist 8-Ball Skull, wer auch immer,
Skull
in die Seile gelangt.
Ja, da packt sich Skull D'Lo. Ja, Side Suplex. Und beide doch jetzt relativ schwer angeschlagen.
Ja, mehr Wirkung, als man das eigentlich glaubt von diesem Manöver. Ziemlich angeschlagen, D'Lo. Kommt aber wieder auf die Beine und schickt dann erneut Mark Henry herein. Naja, ein Manöver ist erlaubt, jetzt muss er natürlich raus, D'Lo. Und gleich, wir haben es gesehen, wieder kein offizieller Wechsel vorlag.
So, jetzt Mark Henry in seinem Element mit Kraftaktionen. Kann er jetzt hier weitermachen. Und ja, kann man natürlich sagen, was man will gegen Mark Henry. Die sind bei ihm sehr, sehr effektvoll. Seine Kraft, die hat er ohne Zweifel.
Das ist seine Domäne. Vor allem, wenn es um die Arme geht. Im Schultergürtelbereich, da ist er in der Tat wohl der Stärkste, zumindest in der Federation. Der stärkste Mann der Welt, da würde ich vielleicht doch den ein oder anderen vor ihm sehen.
Ja, das sehe ich genauso. So, Skull kommt einfach nicht zum Wechseln. Jetzt ist D'Lo wieder an der Reihe. Der geht wieder nach oben. Und was sehen wir?
Ja, low down. Aber 8-Ball ist im rechten Moment zur Stelle, verhindert das Cover. Das wäre es wohl gewesen. Das haben wir alle vier im Ring.
Ja, jetzt gibt es schon wieder eine handfeste Rauferei hier. Und dann ist Paul Ellering da mit seinem Körperchen. Da trifft er aber den Falschen, nämlich 8-Ball. Mark Henry covert ihn. Und das ist der Sieg für D'Lo und Mark Henry.
Here are your winners, the team of D'Lo.
Ja, das war's für heute wieder von...